Gold is trading around $1,247, silver around $17.45, and Bitcoin is trading around $382.60. Today's Bitcoin price brought to you by Express Coin, the fastest and most reliable way to buy Bitcoin. Buy Bitcoin today at expresscoin.com. Support for Liberty Beat comes from Central Texas Gunworks, your online source for firearms, firearm accessories, and ammunition. They take major credit cards and now accept Bitcoin. Visit them online at shop.centraltexasgunworks.com. In the news, on Monday, the U.S. Department of Justice announced they would begin an investigation into the Baltimore Police Department. Officials with the Justice Department, Baltimore Mayor Stephanie Rawlings Blank, Police Commissioner Anthony Batts, and others held a press conference announcing an initiative designed to curb police brutality. The news comes after the Baltimore Sun published their own investigation showing residents suffering broken bones and other injuries during arrests. The DOJ review will study how the officers interact with residents, how the department handles complaints, and review training standards. Civil liberties groups are preparing for an appeal of a California judge's decision regarding the Los Angeles Police Department and the Los Angeles County Sheriff's Department's use of automatic license plate readers. The readers are cameras mounted to police vehicles or other locations such as light poles. They are capable of capturing and storing thousands of license plates from passing vehicles. The Electronic Frontier Foundation and the ACLU of Southern California are seeking to overturn a previous ruling that sided with law enforcement, claiming that the data caught by the readers should not be released to the public. The LAPD and LASD argued that 100% of the information was part of an investigation and therefore should not be released. Water laced with salt and sugar, and gallons of the nasty tasting stuff. Doctors who survived Ebola in Nigeria credited heavy doses of fluids with saving their lives, as the World Health Organization declared the country Ebola-free on Monday. That is a rare victory in the battle against the disease that is ravaging West Africa. Support for Liberty Beat comes from Marjorie Wildcraft's Grow Your Own Groceries, homegrown food on every table. That's growyourowngroceries.org. Support also comes from Midas Resources Incorporated, helping clients convert their paper 401ks and IRAs to solid gold and silver. Get their 10 Reasons book free by calling 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237. This is the Liberty Beat for Tuesday, October 21st, 2014. Check out the website at thelibertybeat.com and like us on Facebook at facebook.com/thelibertybeat. On Tuesday afternoon, the Los Angeles City Council is expected to vote on a ban on growing genetically modified crops, following support gained from local lawmakers on Monday. Council members Mitch O'Farrell and Paul Koritz introduced the measures which would ban the planting and sale of GM seeds, as well as the sale of GM trees and plants. O'Farrell said the ban would be largely symbolic, since there is little agriculture within the city. As U.S. District Court Judge Gladys Kessler waits to rule in the case of force feedings at Guantanamo Bay, new information has been revealed, including a manual on how to treat detainees. Last week, the Department of Justice was granted a 30-day delay until the release of videotapes of the force feeding. The Department of Justice is expected to use the extension in order to appeal the judge's order to release the tapes. During the hearing, the United States government also submitted to the court a copy of the current standard operating procedures for force feeding at Guantanamo Bay. Lawyers with human rights organization Reprieve say the documents offer a disturbing look at the procedures used to forcibly remove detainees from their cells and then force-feed them. Support for Liberty Beat comes from Sovereign Living, a podcast, blog, and reality show about what it takes to live a voluntary and natural life. Check out the blog at sovereignliving.com and watch episode 1 of the soon-to-be-released reality show at sovereignliving.tv. Support also comes from the Be the Media Workshop and Mini Conference, featuring Adam Kokesh and Derek Bros, along with a special Skype appearance by Ben Swan. It happens this Saturday and will be live streamed at thelibertybeat.com/be the media. Be the media and change the world. This is the Liberty Beat for Tuesday, October 21st, 2014. I'm Brian Hagan, reporting. Reminding you, spread liberty with a smile.
Saying that he has no idea what to make of the mixed signals, area man Pete Summers told reporters today he keeps getting ambiguous text messages from local woman Haley Mueller, claiming that she's not at all interested in him.
One minute she's like, I don't want to go out with you. And then she'll mention how she has to go hang out with her boyfriend. I mean, what am I supposed to do with that?
Summers, who first met Mueller at a friend's party last month, informed reporters that the 27-year-old's increasingly perplexing text messages have left him unable to ascertain whether or not she would want to date him. He also noted that Mueller's behavior at social gatherings was equally vague.
Last weekend, we were at a party, and every time I would go up to her, she just said, "Leave me alone." Then I text her the next day, and she totally doesn't even respond. I mean, she just needs to make up her mind and tell me what she wants. She hasn't answered my last three phone calls, so maybe I should go over there and make sure everything's okay.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live, and you can bring up anything you want. Just dial on in toll-free here at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You can join us online over at freetalklive.com. Enjoy the features that we have waiting there for you, and you can do all that. And plus, you can contact us on Skype. Maybe you don't want to be sounding like you're on the phone. You'll actually sound close to being in the studio if you're on with us via Skype. Our Skype username is lrn.fm. There's a headline. Johnny Ray with me here. We'll also be joined by Rich Paul shortly. Johnny Ray, there's a headline here about Americans' gloom marching into the second decade. Do people seem gloomy to you when you're out and about? I mean, you're working in the working world. You're a janitor for a living. Do you think that people are bummed out around the United States, in your experience?
Excellent question. I think that they are. And I'm just projecting from myself, I think, because I feel like my world was brighter back before the collapse.
Really?
Yeah. It seems like the world changed in 2008, and there was a little bit of gloom leading up to it, and it's been just kind of bleak ever since then. It doesn't feel like morning in America.
So Rich Paul joining us here on the third microphone. Good evening, Rich.
Good evening.
So what we're talking about is there's been a study here, and we'll get into some of the details. Wall Street Journal reporting on this on their Washington Wire blog about Americans being not so happy. They're gloomy, as the article claims here, that there were 1,000 potential voters asked whether they think that the nation is on the right or wrong track. 65% of them said the country had taken a wrong turn, and only 25% said the United States was on the right path. And I guess I was asking Johnny Ray, so I'm curious to your opinion, you know, of the people that you know, the sort of just your general life experience. Do you feel like the people that that are in your life are you know, depressed about sort of the state of things in the United States?
Well, the people I hang out with are pissed, mostly. But yeah, they're definitely not happy with the situation as it is, which it would be hard to be happy with it.
I've been doing interviews over the last couple days with media sources. Had a lady call me today asking questions about the Pumpkin Fest riots. We spent all of the entire show last night talking about various different aspects of this international news that has been being generated from Keene. And the lady I was talking to was she wrote for some sort of an education magazine, and she wanted to know more of kind of like the college student side of things. And I'm not a college student, but we do outreach to college students around here and, mm-hmm. you know, touch base with them with Keene Cop Block and give them information about knowing their rights and how to deal with the police. And, you know, some of her questions that she was asking me today were, well, she seemed surprised that there were some issues between the college students and the police here in Keene, as though as though the fact that college students get arrested, getting arrested is unusual for any area, that as though tensions between college students and police are an unusual thing, something that just seemed to like not enter her world. Or maybe I was misinterpreting what she was saying to me. That was the that was how I was taking, you know, the words she was speaking. And so I explained to her, look, yeah, the college students are upset at the police. They're out arresting their friends on a weekly basis. Every single week, weekend. There, you know, there's college parties going on. There's police in the streets arresting people for open container, and police in the streets arresting people for marijuana possession, and police arresting people for, you know, being under the age of 21 in possession with alcohol. And week after week after week, year after year after year, that starts to really wear on people.
And when you enforce unpopular laws, you become the enemy in the eyes of the people.
Right.
If these were peace officers out there who were just protecting property, nobody would be irritated at that except, you know, actual rioters. People were bent on doing property damage or doing damage to people.
That's how I feel about it. So this says here in the story that the only time the public has felt worse than today was in October of 2008, which comes right back to right around the time, Johnny Ray, where you say things changed for you in your life. During the first deep spasms of the recession, at that time, 78% said the nation was on the wrong track, and only about 12% felt good about the country's direction. Which, of course, this is just a generic, you know, question. It doesn't really mean anything. Mm. It's just a sort of a temperature taking of how people are feeling.
And it reminds it. The scale is very undefined. There was a quiz question in my economics class. One of the first quizzes we took, I did this about 5 years ago, and the question was, is America moving toward socialism or is it moving toward capitalism? And I answered, it's moving toward socialism, because I was thinking of it on a scale from like the turn of the century, 1900, through 2010. Well, the answer that he'd wanted was we're moving toward capitalism, because he was looking at it as on a time frame like more or less from the collapse of the Soviet Union, you know. And so, you know, I was seeing a bigger, longer trend than he was seeing. And without putting a time frame on that kind of question, I mean, has it been going? I would say that America's been on the wrong track since the Civil War.
Sure.
How many are with me on that? I don't know.
I'm on board with you there, although some would argue that it was on the wrong track from the day of the signing of the Constitution.
Well, yeah, and I would say that. I would be so much happier, even if there was a government, if I lived in a country where they'd told the slave states, well, I'll tell you what, we're not letting you into our union in the first place because you practice slavery. And by the way, that's going to be part of the Constitution, that doesn't happen.
So the last time the right direction beat out the wrong track was in January of 2004, and the last election cycle where that was the case was 2002. So it's been about a decade now that people in America have consistently felt as though things were on the wrong track here.
Well, I think war will do that to a populace as well. Never-ending war. There's young people at Keene State that don't really remember a time when the U.S. wasn't at war with someone.
Well, one of the things I think is interesting, and you'll hear in a little bit in this article, they interview people, just, you know, pick some Americans and talk to them. Why is the country on the wrong track or whatever? And one lady says that we're not at war.
Wow.
So it just depends on who you ask. So why are people so gloomy? It just might be everything, says pollster Micah Roberts, sounding a bit like Eeyore himself. Mr. Roberts is vice president of Public Opinion Strategies, which along with Heart Research Associates conducted the poll. He says we haven't had a plurality saying right track in over 10 years, so that's pretty amazing. After 10 years, it's just part of the collective consciousness of Americans to think the nation's gone off the rails, he added. The most negative responses came when people were asked, quote, tell me, what are the one or two reasons you feel things in the nation are headed in the right direction or off on the wrong track? A politically independent millennial from California had quite a few more than on her list. She said, quote, disease, economy like Ebola, an economy as in people can't really find jobs. I guess turmoil, like I can't explain it. Senseless slayings, like in St. Louis, downtown, there's cops shooting people for no reason. Public fighting, public riots, public people fighting outside of Congress offices. And there's still a sense of racism. I guess human trafficking. I noticed there were weird public fires in San Diego, and that's all I can think of right now. As if that weren't enough, says the piece over at Wall Street Journal, even those who said they thought the nation was on the right track seemed to doom the future with faint praise. Take this response from a Democrat, middle-aged white woman living in the swing state of Pennsylvania. She said, quote, people are not buying enough. I work for a company, Neiman Marcus, and we sell to the richy rich. Jobs are an issue. and there are none to be had in this area. I believe that free trade killed us.
Oh, God. Well, you know, it's... God, that argument just floors me that, you know, people should be made to produce, to consume the things that I want to produce. And, of course, the answer is no. You should produce the things that people want to consume. And if people's tastes change because they're not as rich as they were before, then find a way to sell cheaper stuff to them.
We'll come back with more here in moments. Did free trade kill us? Get Johnny Ray's thoughts. 855-450-FREE. You can take control and bring up whatever's on your mind. The phones are working tonight, by the way. This is Free Talk Live. Have you thought about owning gold? There are lots of reasons to own precious metals. A hedge against inflation. When the dollar tanks, metals go up. A barter currency. You can disempower the Fed by using real money. And no one knows the future. In an economic collapse, metals are likely to be a currency. Do as I've done for years. Buy your gold and silver and precious metals from Midas Resources through gold.freetalklive.com. That's gold.freetalklive.com. Here's a good idea. When you have a legal matter like creating your will or legally setting up a business with a corporation or LLC, you don't necessarily need a law firm. Use LegalZoom.com. At LegalZoom.com, you answer straightforward questions online and they take care of the rest. They even review your answers for common mistakes and guarantee your satisfaction. Free Talk Live listeners, you'll get 10% off your order by typing in FTL in the referral box at purchase. Don't procrastinate with these important legal documents. LegalZoom.com.
Adam Miller here with Midas Resources. Today, October 15th, 2014, gold opened at $1,246.90. A 1 ounce gold coin can be purchased for $1,292.55, $646.27 for a half ounce, or $323.14 for a quarter ounce. That's $1,292.55, $646.27, and $323.14.
Hi, this is Ted Anderson. Have you ever wondered why banks, stockbrokers, investment advisors won't talk about gold IRAs? Wait a sec. Gold and silver is going up while Congress is trying to settle on the next debt increase. And there's no end to this madness. That old 401k and IRA can be converted into physical gold without tax consequences. I explained this in my book, 10 Reasons to Buy Gold. Don't let time slip away. Call for your free copy today, 800-686-2237. Get away from that Washington spin and get honest answers about gold. 800-686-2237. The book is free, 800-686-2237.
Listen, you've heard the commercials before. Whether you owe $15,000 or $15 million in tax debt to the IRS or state, we can help. On a never-ending payment plan? Penalties and interest killing you? Missing tax returns? Being garnished or levied? Not a problem. If you qualify, we can remove levies and garnishments within days or even hours of hiring our firm. If you've been summoned, or even worse, receiving tax warrants in the mail, call right now. Are you a business owner with back payroll taxes? Is the IRS or state threatening to close your business you've worked so hard to build? Protect yourself and your business. Even if you've tried in the past, new guidelines could potentially qualify you today. So what are you waiting for? We can take that tax monkey off your back.
Call the Tax Monkey now, 800-281-6030, 800-281-6030, 800-281-6030, that's 800-281-6030.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
If there was a place that liberty-minded people had been elected to political positions and were rolling back government, would you move there? If freedom lovers had secured a 20% voting bloc and can veto most bad bills, would you move? Well, the time has come to sign the pledge at freestateproject.org. These things have happened in New Hampshire, and you can join us and help. freestateproject.org. Sign up now at freestateproject.org.
What's up next? Visit the Liberty Radio Network program guide to find out at shows.lrn.fm. That's shows.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. Dial in, bring up whatever's on your mind. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. The story that we're sharing at the moment, we'll talk about open borders coming up here in a little bit. But at the moment, a study, yet another one, they've been doing them for the last couple decades, over how Americans feel about, are things on the right track in the United States? And more interestingly, because that's just sort of this generic question that essentially a temperature take of what people think. But people are very, very different in their opinions on why things are on the wrong track. Lots of people agree that things are on the wrong track. But what that means is something very unique to every individual that that you ask the question. And we'll talk more about that here in a moment. Also, ISIS crisis or more hype? Antiwar.com has the answers. Antiwar.com has the facts and the readership. What Antiwar.com doesn't have is a pot of gold. The war machine has the magic of the Federal Reserve printing press and the mainstream media behind it. All Antiwar.com has is you. Their staff is down to a skeleton crew, accepting minimal pay. They're committed to keeping the website online with the best of the worst of all the bad news in the world about war, but they can't do this for free, and they can't do it without you. They need your donation. Please go to antiwar.com and donate or give them a call today. They proudly and gladly take Bitcoin, by the way. That's antiwar.com/donate, antiwar.com, because war is the health of the state. We continue here with a little bit more from the Wall Street Journal, but first let's go to Tom in Nashua, New Hampshire. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Tom.
Big news story that people coming from three West African countries that are stricken with Ebola coming into the United States can only enter through the five designated airports. Okay, did you see that?
No, I did not.
Yeah, that's a big news story. They just implemented that. You got to come in through one of those five designated airports.
Hmm.
And you know what's unconstitutional about that, of course.
What do you guys think? I'm not jumping in. Nothing's really jumping to mind at the moment besides, interfering with people's right to travel about wherever they want. I don't know if that's specified in the Constitution.
How's this sound? Article 1, Section 9 of the U.S. Constitution, quote, "No preference shall be given by any regulation of commerce or revenue to the ports of one state over those of another, nor shall vessels bound to or from one state be obliged to enter, clear, or pay duties in another." Can't get much clearer than that now, can you? See, so, of course, they don't know nothing about the Constitution.
No,
nobody
checks that thing anymore.
Yeah, well, it's right there. I mean, now everybody knows. Okay.
Thanks, Tom, for the heads up on that. Appreciate it. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. I'm sure the federal government will get right on obeying the Constitution there right after lunch.
Yeah, I probably wouldn't be that pleased to be, one of the designated, we get the Ebola areas. I don't feel that would be much of a privilege, maybe. I don't know. I mean, I'm not particularly scared of Ebola. I think mostly it's you're much more likely to get shot by a cop than
yeah, that's probably
Ebola.
True.
But
even in Africa, Ebola is a very, very small, portion of the people who are dying from, various different infections and diseases and things like that. Diarrhea is a big problem.
AIDS
is a big problem. Ebola, mm-hmm. not so much.
Yeah, Ebola is just horrific looking. So
let's continue here with your calls and thoughts. We've got Greg in Brooklyn. Then coming up, Johnny Ray will tell us if the free market has killed us. Greg, you're on Free Talk Live.
Hey, guys. It's been a while. I haven't called in a long time.
Here you are. Go ahead.
So I wanted to talk about, you guys, yesterday we're talking about Keene, New Hampshire with the riots, and actually, this is not just in Keene, but in Hong Kong now, the protesters are using an app that the government can't censor because it is decentralized.
Mm.
So what that means is it doesn't use a cell phone network, even if they shut down the global internet, they can use Bluetooth to talk to each other.
Oh,
so I
cool.
Wanted...
What's the app? Do you know?
Yeah, the app is called, I think, Fire Chat.
Fire Chat?
Yeah, I tried it myself. It's kind of lame, but it allows you to use the Bluetooth, which is the cool feature of this app.
Hmm. Okay, cool. So it's like just a chat, like kind of an open chat room thing where people can hop into different rooms, that kind of thing?
Yeah, and the nice thing about the Bluetooth is it can create a mesh network. So, for example, if I send a message and your device gets it, it can route it to the device that actually it's intended for without relying on centralized cell phone network.
That's pretty sharp.
So it doesn't go over the internet. It's just peer-to-peer by physical proximity.
Basically, yeah. It's a little bit reminiscent of this project started by Ibn Moglen. It's called the Freedom Box or something like that. Plugs into your electric outlet, and it's designed for those countries where governments might censor communication.
Mm-hmm. Which includes just about every country in the world. you push the government far enough, they're going to crack down and try to do everything to cut lines of communication. So very useful tip, Greg. Anything else you want to share tonight?
Well, I just wanted to opine in a more general way that it's not just governments. I think in general, when you have an institution like Facebook, let's say you have, a billion people on it, or Google or Apple or anything like that, they control the rules of the platform. And what you typically see, it's not just governments. What you typically see is organizations grow in size because it's an arms race, right? Let's say Amazon becomes better at its economies of scale, right? First, it disrupts bookstores and it gets wage slaves, let's say, in warehouses. But then afterwards, it has enough money to do R&D. It replaces them with robots. So it's very efficient.
Well, most of Amazon has been robotic for, I think, most of their history, from what I understand.
Mostly because Amazon started out very small.
As far as their shipping is concerned, as far as the warehouses, most of their packages are picked and packed by robots, from what I understand.
Yeah, although what's your point about warehouses where there are thousands of employees going in and out?
Well, they still have humans. Warehouse. I mean, there's no doubt. They still have to have somebody to do some labor because there's certain things the robots can't do. But where were you going with that, Greg?
Right. So I'm saying that it's a general trend that basically little players, they aggregate. So what happened? So for example, since Amazon is so efficient now, got all these customers, it has tremendous collective buying power. So it can push around all these publishers like Hachette and everything like that. Those publishers will now have to aggregate into a large union and try to push back. And so you get this centralization. Everybody's trying to collectivize in order to not be taken advantage of by this like other collective. And I think that there are these two forces, centralization and decentralization. And when decentralization hits, I think it would be very interesting in the next 5-10 years. Well, I think the internet really enabled that.
If these book wholesalers think that they can sell at a loss and make it up on volume, they've got the whole thing wrong. You got to make a little bit of profit on each item that you're selling. So, as somebody who's been in a business where he was selling things, I certainly wasn't going to say, oh, well, if you buy this from me at below cost, I'll give you lots and lots of it, because that would just, caused me to lose a lot of money.
Yeah, I don't agree necessarily. I mean, I think that I generally support decentralization, and I do agree that the larger the companies get, the more unwieldy they become. But I don't think they're, ending small business. There's plenty of small business out there. I'm not sure if that's what you're getting at. So if you want to hang on, Greg, we'll bring you back. It's Free Talk Live.
Hi, folks. Ronnie McMullen here for Life Change Tea. Healthcare is a problem, whether you're for or against Obamacare. It's a mess. My question is, who do you trust? Do you want to be told what to do, or do you want to make your own decision? My opinion, preventative maintenance. Keeping your colon clean is preventative maintenance. A little exercise, a balanced diet, and drinking Life Change Tea. It tastes great, and it helps with constipation, high cholesterol, liver problems, acid reflux, and much, much more. And with the holiday season upon us, you can get some extra tea for free. Don't wait for Obama. Make your own decision. Order now. Call us at 928-308-0408. That's 928-308-0408. Or you can log on to getthetea.com. That's getthetea.com. Ridding yourself of harmful toxins is truly preventative maintenance. Getthetea.com.
Free Press Publications is an independent, alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary on the website fpp.cc, as well as a daily 5-minute newscast, FPP Radio News, and weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, and the monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
This Your Family Today tip is brought to you by Boost Kit Essentials Nutritionally Complete Drink, providing your picky eater with essential nutrition and great taste in one drink. Visit us at kitessentials.com. To make sure your kids eat healthy, follow the 5-a-day plan. Serve 3 servings of vegetables and 2 servings of fruit daily. Remember, a serving could just mean a piece of fruit or a half cup of veggies. If your kids are picky eaters, ask a nutritionist about other sources. For more tips like these, visit us at parenthood.com/yourfamilytoday.
The 3 most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, 1, share 1 episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. 2, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. 3, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on, joined the Free State Project, and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. Find out about giving to our Google AdWords campaign at amp.freetalklive.com. That's amp.freetalklive.com.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, dial toll-free, bring up anything right here at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We're talking about a poll asking Americans, do they feel as though things are on the right or wrong track? A significant portion of Americans are saying wrong track, 65%. It's interesting to read their responses as to why they think America is on the wrong track. We can continue doing that here in a moment. The we in the studio tonight includes me, Ian.
Rich Paul.
And me, Johnny Ray.
All right, we're going to go right back into your phone calls here, but I also want to let you know about ProXPN. It is a global virtual private network. They sponsor our phone lines here at Free Talk Live, and they are about protecting your communication, specifically encrypting it before it can reach your internet service provider so your ISP can't be snooping on what you're doing online, which is probably what they're doing right now. They're probably logging every website you visit, every search term you enter, in some cases keeping those logs up to 5 years. You can put a stop to that by downloading ProXPN's free software. It's available for Windows, Macintosh, iOS devices, Android devices, as well as Linux users. You can get it set up. It's just a little bit of a different setup for Linux. So you get it set up, get connected, and you're encrypted. So you can get a sweet discount, by the way, on ProXPN by using our discount code FTL50. That's FTL like Free Talk Live. And 50 as in 50% off the price of their annual account, bringing the price down to about $5 per month. And that's good for the lifetime of your account. Plus, you can pay with Bitcoin and save even more. You'll save 62% off of the annual account price by using code FTLBTC and then paying with Bitcoin. Now you get a risk-free 7-day money-back guarantee, so there's nothing to lose but your privacy. And with that premium account, you get unlimited bandwidth, servers around the world you can connect to. You can privately torrent, get past regionally blocked websites, and you can get all the details and get started right now at proxpn.com/FTL. They do not keep records of your online habits. That's proxpn.com/FTL. It's a great discount on privacy. That is priceless. We have Greg still with us listening in New York. And Greg, I don't want to put, you know, words in your mouth. I just want to kind of restate some of what you were saying earlier. And, you know, please correct me if I've misunderstood you. So you were talking about decentralization versus centralization, and you were observing that it seems like companies tend to centralize and get larger in order to compete with one another. And I don't see that as being true necessarily. It's certainly true of some companies that are constantly acquiring more properties and opening new facilities and et cetera, expanding. But other companies seem to be satisfied with being small. You know, like for instance, you mentioned these big box stores or whatever. I purchased a bicycle at Walmart once and it was terrible. So I returned that and I went to a local bike shop and got much better service. I paid more for the bike, but I got much better service out of the deal, and I've been going back to that shop ever since. And I don't think that particular shop has any interest in expanding itself to different markets. Just they seem happy with just servicing the customers that they currently have. And you know, I don't know what the breakdown is as far as small businesses to large businesses here in the Keene area of New Hampshire where we live, but it certainly seems like there's a, you know, small businesses aplenty here. Is that what you were getting at? Were you suggesting that the trend among companies to centralize, or what were you saying?
Well, kind of. What I was saying is pretty abstract. I mean, it's certainly true that small businesses can give you a lot more personal attention and more personal service, and sometimes better service, you know, taking advantage of existing infrastructure. But what I was saying basically is that the theme on, I think, on your radio show is very much about liberty. And liberty is, you know, individual liberty is very important. And I'm talking about, if you look at what is the general theme, where do you find the least liberty and, you know, the outcome? So there's a sort of trade-off. Organizations tend to, like I said, our larger organizations can dominate smaller ones, just like, you know, large animals can maybe dominate small ones in power. And so there's this trend for organizations to take advantage of the economies of scale, do things like, you know, automate a lot of their process, and just generally become more efficient. So someone cannot build a computer like Apple Computer. They can't just compete with them. But there's a dark side to this if you push it too far.
What do you mean they can't? Hold on. Before you go on to the dark side, when you say you can't compete with Apple, I'm not sure what you're getting at. Apple computers tend to be overpriced compared to like a homebrew. Like Rich Paul, you were talking about how you could build your own computer. I can do that same thing. And I've never bought a computer from any sort of company.
Yeah, I mean, there's a lot of credible competitors in the computer business. If you're looking for an area without competition, you haven't found it. And there's also a variety of different offerings. I mean, you can run Apple and Macintosh stuff if that's what you're into, but you can run PC compatible, you know, or you can just these days do it all on your phone if your needs aren't very
Your thoughts, Dave? Your thoughts, Greg?
Yeah, but I mean, if, you know, try to build your own iPhone, negotiate contracts with all the manufacturers and now the banks for the Apple Pay, and then all the regulatory issues, all the, you know, engineer training and the know-how and the patents. I mean, at some point, there's just too much stuff for a small company to replicate all of that. Certainly, they have a head start. And all I'm trying to say is that there are advantages to this, and people do pay for that convenience. They pay Amazon, they pay Apple, they pay all these companies because it's convenient. And I think that's a reason why people also live in the state, and that's why they're sort of okay with that, because the service that they get is pretty okay and has that economy of scale.
Boy, that's a big jump there. So you're jumping from saying that people are okay with doing business with big corporations because it's convenient, and so therefore people also are okay with the state because it's somehow convenient.
And it's also impossible to know if people like being a part of the state because they don't have the option. A lot of people would say that they would voluntarily choose to be a part of the state.
Well, Johnny
and that's
Ray,
really interesting, but you don't have the choice, so there's no way of knowing.
But Johnny Ray, there are polls that show that Americans are saying that the government doesn't have the consent of the governed. So there are actually polls that have asked, I think, the right questions of Americans saying, hey, you know, do you really think that you belong in this deal? I mean, did you agree to this? Did you consent to this whole government thing? And a significant number of Americans, I'll have to pull it up, I feel like it was in the 60th percentile, were saying they did not consent to this government.
Yeah, I saw a poll when I was in jail, and this was published in the newspaper, that said something like 23% of Americans wanted their individual state to secede from
That's
the
correct.
Union. And that was so encouraging to me that people are starting to wake up and say this federal government is an albatross around our necks.
Yep. So here's the poll from Rasmussen Reports, January of 2014. Just 21%. To be clear, this is only of U.S. voters. Just 21% of likely U.S. voters believe the federal government today has the consent of the governed. So you got about 1 in 5, Greg, who seem to think that the government is okay. The rest of them say they don't consent.
That's what I'm saying. I mean, don't just focus on the American government. I mean, Scotland wanted to secede just recently, right? There's a lot of these decentralization aspects, and this is what I'm trying to say. Yeah, you know, you can change the government, but people will generally still think in terms of, oh, we need some kind of large organization. I guess the difference.
Well, people used to think that slavery was an okay idea too.
Yeah. I mean, large doesn't bother me. Large and oppressive bothers me. If a company gets large, like, say, Standard Oil under Rockefeller, got very large at various times. They had 88% of the market. Then they fell to 64% of the market right when they were broken up. And they were large, but they delivered great service, and the prices fell during the whole time that they were growing. So with large.
Right. If you've gotten large based on satisfying your customers, then that's good. If you've gotten large based on teaming up with the government so you can outlaw competition and keep upstarts out of the marketplace and put the mom and pop businesses out of business, then anytime you start using the state to achieve business success, then I got a problem with that.
And a great book on that.
I agree with all that.
Good. Hey, we agree. Thanks, Greg, for the call tonight. 855-450-FREE. That's the toll-free number.
A great book on the subject you were talking about, political versus market entrepreneurs, is The Myth of the Robber Barons. And I believe the author was Barton Fullerton, but I read it in jail and it was fantastic.
I'll get a
reference for it.
Our toll-free number tonight, again, 855-450-FREE. Join us via Skype as well. Our Skype username is lrn.fm. Feel free to get in touch with whatever's on your mind here at Free Talk Live.
The event you've been waiting for is here. Lumber Liquidators' 3rd Annual Fall Flooring Yard Sale. It's your chance to get first quality, full warranty, direct from the mill flooring at unbelievable closeout prices. Like oak laminate for an incredible 19 cents a square foot. And pre-finished 3/4 inch solid maple for just $149. Plus beautiful bamboo for 63% less than other stores. Take advantage of our 20 years of savings with 20-month special financing. And get even more unheard of flooring deals in our stores. Fall Flooring Yard Sale is Thursday through Monday only. Visit LumberLiquidators.com to find a store near you.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
The experts at Web.com want to build your business a successful website for free, just like we did for these current Web.com customers.
We've used and looked at other website designers, but there's nobody better than Web.com.
Web.com can build your website in as little as 7 days free. Plus, we'll promote it on all the major search engines like Google, Yahoo, and Bing. If after 30 days you're happy, we'll continue to provide promotion, hosting, support, and maintenance, all for one low monthly fee. If not, cancel and pay nothing.
If you're in business today and you don't have a web presence, you won't be taken seriously.
Call right now and you'll also get a free .com or .net domain name for your new website powered by VeriSign, the world's leading domain name provider.
Call 800-297-0154. That's 800-297-0154.
No upfront charge for site build, after which ongoing fees apply. Rights to site are relinquished when canceled. Domain included during active service, after which fees apply.
That's 800-297-0154.
Keenvention is coming up October 31st through November 2nd. Get your tickets now at keenvention.info. Keenvention is your chance to meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire. You can explore the beautiful little city of Keene, discuss various forms of activism with seasoned veterans, attend social events like the costume party. Keenvention received rave reviews last year. If you missed it, visit keenvention.info for full video coverage of every speaker and panel. This year, James Robin Hood Cleveland, Rich Paul, and Free State Project President Carla Garrick will be keynoting. And we'll have all kinds of panels, including the new Cop Block panel and the new Movers panel hosted by the outlaw Josie Wales. Join old and new friends and neighbors in Keene for Keenvention this October 31st through November 2nd. Only 100 tickets are available in advance, so lock yours in now for just $60 or with Bitcoin. Reserve your tickets now at keenvention.info. Visit keenvention.info for more, or look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info. If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
Are you a political activist who does things that the government might not like? Then this free ebook may save your life. Rats is your guide to protecting yourself against snitches, informers, informants, agents provocateur, narcs, finks, and similar vermin. Rats was written by OG libertarian Claire Wolf. Rats is a short book, easy to read, and available free in many formats. Download Rats free at rats-nosnitch.com. That's rats-nosnitch.com.
You can watch the LRN Studio Cam and chat with other listeners anytime at cam.lrn.fm. That's cam.lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live. Take control here and bring up anything that you want. 855-450-FREE. That's toll-free. Brought to you by ProXPN. 855-450-3733. If you want to help support Free Talk Live, one of the best ways to do it is to become a Free Talk Live amplifier for $5 per month. We will take that $5 and invest it into more outreach to radio stations, to people listening on the internet, to people listening via satellite. We want to expand in all of those areas, and the AMP program allows us to do that. So please go to amp.freetalklive.com. You'll get perks as well. You get benefits like access to the AMP-only call-in lines, the AMP-only podcast, the AMP-only Facebook group, and more. Go to amp.freetalklive.com to get signed up. That's amp.freetalklive.com. Let's continue with your calls and thoughts, and we'll get back to more Americans' viewpoints on why things are on the wrong track. What are Americans saying in detail as far as what are their top reason or two reasons as to why they believe that that is the case? We'll continue with that discussion, but Dave is on the line in New York. First, you're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Dave.
Hi, how you doing?
What's on your mind, Dave?
Okay, the other night when I called in and I was talking to you guys about how my next door neighbor, he's always slamming his door and all that stuff, you guys had actually abruptly just like hung up on me while I was in the middle of a sentence. You guys just rudely hung up on me in the middle of a sentence when I was trying to get my thoughts out, and I think that is very...
Well, Dave,
very,
you have a habit of repeating yourself over and over again, so I suspect...
of you guys to do that.
Yeah, I suspect that you were repeating yourself, and so therefore, whoever was in charge of the phones at that time was probably, you know, ready to let you go. And if you felt that it was rude, then, you know, I apologize that you felt that way, but, you know, we try to say thanks for the call whenever, you know, we're done talking to folks and try to show some appreciation.
Mm-hmm. It was you that was in charge of the phone. It was you, Mark, and I guess it was somebody else. And I was telling you that, you know,
that was me.
My neighbor was just saying, yeah, whoever. Anyway, the point is, I don't like being hung on. I don't like being hung up on in the middle of a sentence when I'm trying to get my thoughts out.
There you go. I just hung up on you at the end of your sentence there.
I was going to suggest that. Thank you, sir.
855-450-FREE. That is the Pro XPN toll-free line. That's 855-450-3733. People, I don't think, understand what, you know, talk radio is doing, at least on Free Talk Live. We're kind of a different show than your typical talk radio program. Many talk shows do not even take phone calls, or hardly ever will open the phones, as
what
they call
never.
It. Rush Limbaugh, for instance, you know, one of the most popular talk show hosts in the most, arguably the most popular talk show host in the United States. He hardly ever takes open phone calls.
All the talk show hosts that I grew up listening to, including Rush, would the callers that they had on, the callers would ask their question. You know, after all of that body of callers being heavily screened, they would ask their question, yeah. and then it was just an opportunity for the host to hold forth for minutes upon minutes.
Right. Almost never will the caller get a chance to rebut the host after, you know, as you say, that the caller will ask a question, the host will pop the caller down or hang up on them after the question, and then just go off and rant or whatever, expound on that question, while the caller may have wanted to say something in response to the host's response to their question. Most of the time, they never get a chance. Here on Free Talk Live, you'll usually get that chance unless you call in and drop the F-bomb or the S-bomb or something else that we have to, you know, drop your call. If you're just really, really boring, you're not going to last very long. The more interesting your call, the more likely we'll keep you on for a little while. But at the same time, you know, if we've got other folks who are waiting patiently to get on the air, then, you know, to some extent, we want to give everybody as much of a shot to get their thoughts out as well. So, you know, there's never a guarantee that you're going to call into this show or any show and be given all of the time that you need to make all of the points that you wanted to make. What we do promise you is that you'll be able to call into Free Talk Live and bring up whatever you want. Now, whether or not, you know, we find your topic particularly interesting is another question.
Yeah. Well, I used to have a sign up in my business that said, "Welcome to Riches. Please be profitable, be interesting, or be gone."
Beyond.
Now, Ian, if Christians call in and they're very proud of their Christianity, you have little patience with that, it seems, sometimes.
I don't know. I'm not sure about that. You think so?
I do. I definitely do.
But I don't know. I like Christians. I mean, the ones that are like real Christians who don't want to use the government to bomb people in other countries and stuff like that.
Maybe it is. Maybe you just sniff out the ones that are socialistic Christians and you put the kibosh on whatever they're saying.
There's Christians. We've had Christians in our studio. Daryl Perry, our Friday night co-host, is a Christian.
Michelle Seven was
on the show for a number of years, and she was a very devout Christian. Varen Swearingen, the former president of the Free State Project, is a Christian and a very devout one. And, you know, Russell Canning, one of the reasons I moved to Keene, is also a very devoted Christian. So no, I don't think I don't feel like that's true, Johnny Ray. And if, you know, if you feel like you catch me doing that to somebody who is a Christian who respects the rights of others and doesn't want to, you know, shove their religion down someone's throat,
I will pounce.
Jump
if
all
I
over
hear
me.
It, I'll pounce.
Yeah, because I don't think there's anything wrong with, you know, a lot of my understanding of Jesus is that he was a guy about peace, not that he was some sort of crazed killer who wanted to murder brown people. I think that he was somebody that was in favor of forgiveness and loving his enemy, and I think those are all great things that more Christians should try out. I think that many of them fail very miserably at trying to emulate their supposed savior.
I heard a comedian say that some Christians came up to him after a show and said, "We are Christians. We didn't like what you had to say." And he said, "Well, so forgive me."
So share your thoughts here at 855-450-FREE. Johnny Ray, the lady responding to this survey that the Wall Street Journal is reporting on,
She blamed the free market.
She's a Democrat, middle-aged white woman living in Pennsylvania. When asked what it is, what are the, you know, one or two things that she thinks are really off the rails about the United States? Why are things on the wrong track, as the questionnaire, the poll here had to say? So her answer was that she's talking about how she works for Neiman Marcus. They sell to rich people. She says jobs are an issue. There are none to be had in this area. I believe free trade killed us. I believe it's done that. I don't know. There are things that are going in the right direction. This wasn't done by one president, meaning the damage. As far as I'm concerned, jobs are the most important. The health care. A lot of the companies aren't hiring because they have to pay the health insurance. A minimum wage is disgusting. The minimum wage. She says people are not making a living on minimum wage. Anything under $10 an hour is not a wage. And I believe the minimum wage should be raised. Now, we can come to the minimum wage, I think, in the next hour, because that's always interesting, an interesting discussion to have. But
you
Johnny
saw
Ray,
me ready to pounce.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. So, but Johnny Ray, did free trade kill us?
No, free trade didn't kill us. And the United States has never really had a system of free trade.
Mm-hmm.
The U.S. Constitution is full of perversions to the free and open markets.
Right. One of the constitutional taxes is a tariff.
Exactly.
It's written right in there. So that would be another example of how the United States has been on the wrong track, in my opinion, from day number one.
Although in those days, a general tariff would generally be charged on all goods coming in.
Still
rather
not
than,
free trade.
Usually it would be a couple of percent. It was intended to raise revenue and not to cut off imports, like many of the tariffs we see today that we'll see it. You know, the price of sugar in the United States is three times what it is anywhere else.
No, I mean, I understand the argument you're making, but it's still not free trade, right?
Like, it's still not completely free.
If the government's saying, okay, well, it's a flat 2% across the board on every product coming in as a tariff, that's still 2% more than a free trade port would be charging, right? Which would be 0%.
Absolutely.
Yeah, and that's a tax on importers, which is a specific portion of the population. Mm-hmm. So it's a perversion of the market. And free trade is not what we have. It's not what we've had for a long time. I could probably explain free trade in a paragraph, but the free trade legislation we have is hundreds, maybe thousands of pages long.
Yeah, well, do they call that free trade or fair trade?
Well, NAFTA is called a free trade agreement, but it's thousands of pages long, like he says.
That's ridiculous.
That's mercantilism. That's not capitalism.
Yeah, how anybody could look at these agreements between the countries and label them as free trade just baffles me. I mean, do they just take it at face value? Oh, well, it says, the title of the legislation says it's free trade, or the agreement says it's a free trade, so it must be free. I mean, really? People don't realize that that's, you know, any burden besides zero is not free?
Yeah, it's one of the few places where free in price and free in freedom is the same.
So you can share your thoughts. Do you think that things are going on the wrong direction? I imagine most people listening think so. But maybe you think everything is just copacetic here in the United States. You're in the 25% who are saying that it's going in the right direction. Would
I
love
want
to hear
some
from
of
you.
What you're taking.
Would love to hear from you at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We'll share a little bit more here on what Americans are saying about why things are on the right and or wrong track, according to the story here, and you can share your thoughts as well. Plus, you can join us via Skype. Our Skype username is lrn.fm. There's more coming up in moments. Free Talk Live.
Majid lives in Nor Deven, Armenia, with his wife, kids, and grandkids, all in the same house. They have cows, but to compete against the big ranchers, Majid needed to get a loan for more cattle. Free Talk Live helped him get a loan for the cows. He bought them, and now he's very happy with the expansion of his farm. You can help us help more people by getting your coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com. Make a difference, one cup at a time. Get a free pound to try out the subscription. Cancel at any time. coffee.freetalklive.com. Talk radio generally and Free Talk Live specifically are a really inexpensive way to reach customers. All advertising is about return on investment. If you keep your investment low, you have a better chance of seeing a proper return. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations and the internet, reaching hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, mark@freetalklive.com.
If you want to move to the free state and you're looking for some real estate, well, I know a guy who's really great. It's the realtor Mark Warden. Do you want a home with 20 acres, a lakeside cabin, any takers for renters, buyers?
buyers and sellers too. Mark Warden is the guy for you. PorcupineRealEstate.com.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats and the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's posts pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. facebook.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Tuesday, October 21st, 2014. Silver is trading at $17.55 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,252 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $388. Antiwar.com reports, having apparently lulled Iraq's Kurdistan regional government into a false sense of security, the Islamic State launched a series of 15 simultaneous attacks across their frontier yesterday, testing their defenses and seizing some small towns. Also part of the slain territory was the town of Qaratapa, not far from the city of Mosul, where the Islamic State fighters infiltrated the town disguised as Peshmerga and then fought off Kurdish reinforcements. The attacks appeared to coincide with Turkey's announcement that they are going to allow Peshmerga fighters to traverse Turkey to enter Syria and fight the Islamic State fighters over Kurdish territory there. With the Islamic State focused on the Syrian Kurds in the Iraqi Anbar province lately, there hasn't been much fighting with the Peshmerga, which would free them up to fight elsewhere. The attacks by the Islamic State may aim at changing that equation or may reflect that with U.S. airstrikes focused elsewhere, the Kurdish territory isn't as defensible as it once was. FPP Radio News is brought to you by Roberts & Roberts Brokerage. For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They now take Bitcoin for purchasing precious metals so you can turn your profits into a long-term investment. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing. 800-874-9760. The Associated Press reports Colorado health authorities suggested banning many forms of edible marijuana, including brownies and cookies, then whipsawed away from the suggestion Monday after it went public. The Colorado Department of Health and Environment told state cannabis regulators that they should limit edible cannabis on shelves to hard lozenges and tinctures, which are a form of liquid cannabis that can be added to food and drinks. The suggestion sparked marijuana industry outrage and legal concerns from a regulatory work group that met Monday to review the agency's suggestion. Colorado's 2012 marijuana legalization measure says retail cannabis is legal in all forms. Karen McGowan, the department's deputy executive director, said, "If the horse wasn't already out of the barn, I think that would be a nice proposal for us to put on the table." Talking to reporters after the work group reviewed the department's proposal, McGowan insisted the edibles ban was just one of several proposals under review by cannabis regulators. Lawmakers have ordered state cannabis regulators to require cannabis-infused food and drink to have a distinct look when they are out of the packaging. The order came after concerns about the proliferation of cannabis-infused treats that many worry could be accidentally eaten by children. Statewide numbers are not available, but one hospital in the Denver area has reported 9 cases of children being admitted after accidentally eating cannabis. It is not clear whether those kids ate commercially packaged cannabis products or homemade items. ExpressCoin is the best choice for buying Bitcoin, Litecoin, Dogecoin, and more. ExpressCoin prides themselves on their customer service, so much so that the back end on the website should allow them to be even more focused on your needs. Get your cryptocurrencies with money order, check, wire transfer, or cash deposit. Get started at expresscoin.fppradio.com. That's expresscoin.fppradio.com. Reuters reports, Court records released on Monday show Alabama's powerful Republican State House Speaker was indicted on 23 criminal counts of corruption by a grand jury. Mike Hubbard, who helped guide Republicans to majorities in both houses of the Alabama legislature in 2010 for the first time in 136 years, was indicted on Friday of charges that included using his office for personal gain and legislating with a conflict of interest. According to the indictment handed down by a grand jury in Lee County, Hubbard solicited favors from a range of powerful Alabamians, including former Governor Bob Riley and several business leaders. The charges are all Class B felonies, which under state law each carry a minimum of 2 years and a maximum penalty of 20 years in prison and a $30,000 fine. Speaking outside the Lee County Jail on Monday, Hubbard's attorney, Mark White, said he would fight the charges. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Overburdened with material comforts, America's wealthy can expect another disappointing holiday this year. As Brian Scott tells us, the rich will simply be buying too many things to experience the true meaning of Christmas.
All across the country, those at the top of the economic ladder are denied a privilege that the poorest of the poor take for granted. Rather than fall victim to the rampant consumerism that seems to increase each year, the poor find meaningful joy in simple Christmas traditions, like singing carols to keep warm and hugging relatives who have not yet died. At stores like these, the spiritually bereft must scramble for popular holiday toys in a vain attempt to duplicate the Christmastime happiness that the impoverished enjoy.
Poor people are grateful for just a roof over their heads or something to eat. My wife and I are both lawyers, so that's not enough for us. I certainly hope poor people don't take what they don't have for granted.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live. You can dial in toll-free here and share your thoughts with us on whatever you'd like to talk about. The number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And we've got Skype. Our Skype username is lrn.fm. The study that we were talking about in the first hour, for those of you just tuning in, the Wall Street Journal is giving details about. It's a long study that's been going on over many years, since as early as 1990, asking Americans what they think about, you know, is the country on the right track or the wrong track? And it turns out that right now, about 65% of the respondents to the poll, about 1,000 potential voters, are being asked this. So I always would like to hear what average Americans think, because the average American may not be a potential voter. So that, you know, we're leaving those people out. So as far as voters are concerned, even of the voters, there's a lot of frustration among Americans. But the really interesting part about this story to me is what they're saying in response to the question of, well, why? Why is it on the right or the wrong track? What are your reasons for that? We'll continue that discussion here in a moment. With you tonight in the studio, it's Ian here.
Rich Paul.
And Johnny Ray.
Let's jump into your phone calls first. Pete is on the line in California. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Pete.
Let me ask you something. Don't you think it's kind of ridiculous that the homosexual community always is going to point at somebody being a bully or a bigot, but and especially the Christians? But yeah, they're not going to point at Sharia law that hacks their head off and advocates the killing of them. I think that's kind of hypocritical. I want you to weigh in on that.
Well, first of all, you picked the wrong – number one, you picked the wrong night to call the show, Pete. We do have we do have a gay gentleman on the show on Monday nights. His name is Derek J. And
Sharia law says he needs to be beheaded.
So
what about Sharia law?
First of all, I don't think you really know much about Sharia law. I mean, what kind of research have you done on it?
Believe me, there's plenty of research.
No, I don't believe you.
And I know in their surahs, I read a piece. It said basically it's called forceful conversion.
Who was the piece written by?
It was written by a Jewish guy that wrote in the paper.
You should try talking to some Muslims. I'm going to go out on a limb here and say maybe you should try talking to some Muslims and learn a thing or two about Sharia law before you start spouting off about it.
And I'll go up off on a limb.
All right.
And suggest that
goodbye, Pete.
Most of the gay people I know would object to being beheaded.
Yeah.
I don't know any that would, you know,
absolutely
be down with that.
So I'll answer Pete's question, now that he's gone. this guy, by the way, Pete, the first time he called the show was advocating violence. He hates gay people. He hates all kinds of people. Anyway, and he also calls himself a Christian at the same time, which is Pete's an example of one of those Christians that I don't think is a real Christian. But all that said, to get to his question, you know, why doesn't the gay community speak out against the Muslims trying to cut their heads off? Well, first of all, that's not a problem that gay people in America face. There's not any problem of rash of beheadings, not even really any beheadings. There was a couple beheadings in Oklahoma, but that was a workplace violence. Or there was one beheading in Oklahoma like a
good
month
Lord.
Ago. It was workplace violence. The guy that did the beheading was really crazy and, you know, just a nut job. It didn't have anything to do with
it. Is it bad that I thought at least he didn't use a gun? You know, didn't create that political problem for us by going and killing his coworkers with a gun.
Well, it was happening along the same time as these beheading videos were coming out of, supposedly coming from ISIS. And so the headlines made it sound like there's a Muslim beheading people in the United States. But this guy, while he thought he was a Muslim, didn't even really have the basic chops down, according to Will Cawley from Muslims for Liberty. We had him on the show to kind of talk about things, how this guy was so confused, like he was mixing a Muslim name with like a Rastafarian name, and he like didn't even know what he was doing. So anyway, my point to Pete is gay people in America don't face that kind of persecution. Now, if that's happening in other parts of the world, and I believe that sort of persecution is happening, like, you know, in other places like Uganda, it's illegal to be gay, and they were trying to put people to death there through the government system. Thankfully, that didn't go through, but there's still serious punishments for people who are gay in places like Uganda and in Russia as well. Those are two countries I've heard about, so I'm sure there are many more than that where there's some serious issues of violence affecting gay people, whether it be through the government or through, you know, the certain religious sects or whatever. But, you know, I know Muslims and I know they know gay people and are friends with gay people. So they haven't yet attempted to cut anyone's head off or do any kind of physical bodily harm to their gay friends. So I think that the reason why you don't hear gay people speaking out about their concern over maybe some extremist Muslims who might possibly advocate for their harm is because it's not something that they face. What they do face is hatred. They do face bigotry. They do face discrimination in you know, very negative ways that in some cases can erupt in violence. They face beatings. They face threats. And, you know, they face those things from different kinds of people, not just Christians, but just from people who don't understand, you know, being gay and who don't accept it and who are very, very rude towards them.
Well, the Bible says they should be stoned, so, you know, I'll get stoned.
You can help
with
that.
Yeah.
All of the religions of the book, which I believe are that's a phrase I've heard, and I think it means Christianity, Islam, and Judaism.
That's correct.
Can all point to these extreme methods of justice and following God's way, these homicidal ways of keeping God's ways and keeping, I don't know, God's covenant.
Okay.
But the, so Christians, our religion or the Christian religion can be described as bloodthirsty also. And in
it
Islam,
depends on your interpretation.
Yeah. And, and Jesus is a prophet to Muslims.
That's correct.
So if Jesus came and made the Old Testament, made those things, those rules no longer valid, then it is so in Islam as well, because Jesus is a prophet of Islam. The Muslims anticipate the second coming of Jesus. If Jesus said that, then he was a prophet.
Well, I don't think they anticipate the second coming of Jesus. The Muslims don't anticipate that, but it's I believe in the religion of Islam, they do understand that new prophets will come along over time. I think that that's true. I don't think they believe that Muhammad was the final prophet.
I think I believe that is.
That
we
they
should
do
check.
Think Muhammad
should,
is the final
I think
prophet?
That's one of the defining aspects of Islam is that Muhammad is the last
final
prophet.
One? Really? Okay. Then maybe I'm misremembering, because I thought that that they understood that, you know, new teachings, new interpretations come down over time. But maybe I misunderstood.
I'm pretty sure they chant there is only one Allah and Muhammad is his prophet rather than one of his prophets.
Okay.
So, but that's just, I don't think that's maybe the case. I just heard that in a movie.
Because I know it's true that they think that Jesus was a prophet as well prior to Muhammad.
Yeah, they do. They do accept some of the earlier prophets, but I think the idea is he was the last one.
So this is a problem with people who aren't really intimately familiar with a religion, really kind of speculating about what various different aspects of it are. That's why I love Will Cawley from Muslims for Liberty. He's just well educated about various different aspects of Islam and the different sects, if you will, and what some of the differences are between them. And we actually had him on for 3 hours. It was probably about a month ago. It was one of our Saturday shows. Great resource, I think, for people that really want to learn more about being a Muslim and living in America and how compatible, at least according to Will, the religion is with ideas of voluntarism, which there's a great book written by Dobby Barker called Voluntary Islam, which I have read, and I would recommend. It's very, very good. Johnny Ray, did you find anything?
I did, from Wikipedia, one of my very favorite websites. Muhammad is almost universally considered by Muslims as the last prophet by God to mankind.
All right. Well, seems kind of silly that they wouldn't send any more from that point on, but what can you do?
Well, I got my info regarding their belief that Jesus would return from Will Gregg's fantastic website, Freedom Zealot. Fantastic podcast, Freedom Zealot.
He does a podcast?
Yes.
Oh, okay. I know he used to do a radio show, and he stopped doing that radio show, so it's good to know that he's back in the podcast world. I'll have to look into that maybe for LRN.FM.
Oh, yeah, it'd be an excellent addition. It's relatively new.
Oh, okay, great. So we'll come back with more here. You can share your thoughts. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Is the country on the wrong track? And if so, why? We'll find out what more Americans think here in moments. Free Talk Live.
Look, kid. When guys like us walk into a facility in the morning, we can smell a problem. No one needs to hand us a work order. We already know it. Today, for instance, we need a new gearbox, 6 globe valves, and a dozen ballasts. And when I smell a problem, Granger smells that I smell a problem. They help me keep this place up and running. Now that's the kind of smell I like. The sweet smell of success. Get it? Got it? Good. Call, click Granger.com, or stop by. Granger, for the ones who get it done.
Are you searching for your soulmate? Someone you can trust, who will never betray you, or cooperate with the NSA? Stop searching. With EasyDNS, you found a keeper. EasyDNS does it all. Domain names, web hosting, and managed WordPress hosting. EasyDNS stands up for your internet freedom, and with servers in Canada, they do not cooperate with the NSA. Go to EasyDNS.com. You'll love their services or get a full refund. They guarantee it. And they accept Bitcoin. That's EasyDNS.com.
Gold. It's like nothing else on Earth. From the Romans through the Renaissance, from the Industrial Age to the Space Age, gold has weathered the test of time. For 6,000 years, gold has remained the ultimate store of wealth. According to the World Gold Council and the U.S. Mint, demand is at an all-time high. The stage is being set for the reemergence of gold as the common-sense alternative to a fiat paper currency that gets weaker every day. Midas Resources is proud to offer the hard-hitting report that arms you with the truth you need to protect you and your family from the Fed's plans for your hard-earned money. Don't gamble with your future. Call Midas Resources today and ask for your free copy of As Good as Gold. Call 1-800-686-2233 for the report the Fed hopes you'll never see. As Good as Gold can be yours by calling 800-686-2237. If you have ever thought about owning gold, you must read this report. Call Midas today at 800-686-2237.
Americans across the nation made their voices heard this week as they demanded more mind-blowing guitar solos. Calling for the solos to be, quote, face-meltingly cool and go on for well over 10 minutes, Americans stressed that all guitar solos from now on should be equally as kick-ass as those in Van Halen's Hot for Teacher and AC/DC's Thunderstruck, or even better.
It should start out really slow, you know, and then get faster and faster until they're all the way up at the top of the guitar neck and bending the notes like crazy, so it's like, and then there's all this awesome pyrotechnic stuff going off in the background. They should all be like that.
And in this week's local news, a report noted that on its surface, Glenbrook, Ohio is a small town like any other, a peaceful, all-American town. And yet, the report's authors added, if you only look closer, what you find may surprise you. In other news, a man is just having one of those decades where he doesn't feel like doing anything.
This is the Onion News Network.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
Are you tired of governments murdering people around the world? Stop using their money. There is an alternative. Bitcoin is a stateless, free market, non-political currency. Bitcoin cannot be inflated or controlled by any government. By using their money, you are helping the state. Stop doing it. You have an incredible alternative available now. Learn it, use it, spread it. Get started with Bitcoin at weusecoins.com. That's weusecoins.com.
You're listening to the best liberty-oriented audio streamed around the clock, on the air, and online. This is the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.fm.
Free Talk Live, dial toll-free, bring up anything here at 855-450-FREE. We are going to share some more excerpts from this study, a poll of Americans, likely voter types, and what they think about the country. Is it on the wrong track? Well, most Americans say, yeah, 65% of them say it's on the wrong track. But why? That's the more important question. What is it that Americans think is wrong tracked about America? We'll get into that here. And at coffee.freetalklive.com, you can get hooked up with a free pound of some of the best coffee out there from BuzzBox. It's shade-grown, 100% organic, top 1% grade Arabica. And it is competitively priced with other high-end coffees. You get to coffee.freetalklive.com, get signed up for their auto ship program. You get your first pound free. You just pay the shipping cost, and it'll get to you. That's how much they think that you're going to really like their coffee. They're willing to give you an entire pound for free. It's great stuff from what I understand. And they also do something that's really great. They've teamed up with us and Kiva.org to help us change lives by offering people in poverty an opportunity to change their own lives by getting a microloan. And the way we do these microloans is every 10 Free Talk Live listeners who signs up over at coffee.freetalklive.com, for every 10 listeners that signs up, we can fund a new microloan. In fact, Mark just apparently sent a couple out just the other day. And once that microloan is paid off, we will then reinvest that money. We'll reloan that money back out to yet another individual who wants to, you know, buy something to improve their business or whatever it is they need that loan for. So go to coffee.freetalklive.com. Again, you get a free pound of coffee. You just pay the shipping cost, and you can cancel your subscription at any time should you wish to. Coffee.freetalklive.com. Let's go to Dustin. He's in North Carolina. You're on Free Talk Live. Hey, Dustin.
Hey, how's it going?
Hey, what's on your mind tonight?
Well, I just wanted to call in real quick. I'm Muslim, based in North Carolina. I'm actually the editor of Carolina Muslims Magazine.
Ah, assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam.
Very good, sir.
And thank you for the greeting. And, you know, the fella called in a little bit ago and was going a little crazy about the gays and Sharia law and everything. And,
how many, excuse me, Dustin, how many heads have you cut off of gay people?
Gay people, none. Chickens, a few.
So what is it? I mean, is there anything to what he's saying? Are there certain Muslim sects who believe in doing violence against gay people?
Absolutely. Just like there are Christian sects that believe in violence against gay people, mm-hmm. just like there are non-religious sects that believe in violence against gay people. You know, gay people have been marginalized for centuries. You know, as long as we can find in recorded history, there's a marginalization. What's interesting, though, is the Quran actually says to confine them in their homes until a way can be made for them. That's the direct statement out of the Quran. And, you know, there's a lot of difference of opinion about what the way is. And I can say that, you know, the non-aggression principle is 100% in keeping with what the core of Sharia is. So basically, if a gay person is Muslim, then I would have the right to go and talk to him and say, listen, man, this is, you know, our religion forbids this. We need to find a way to talk to you about this and, you know, deal with it in some fashion. But if he's not Muslim, I have no right to say anything to him about it, you know, because there's the Sharia law is for Muslims.
Hmm. Now, what we were talking with Will Cawley from Muslims for Liberty a little while ago, and he was explaining Sharia law to essentially just be the practices of a Muslim. So, like, how do you wash your feet? Well, that's defined in Sharia law. Is that accurate?
Right.
How would you define what Sharia law is? Because it seems like a lot of people
Sharia
seem to
law.
Think it's a list of violence that should be brought against people.
Well, and that's one thing. The first thing that everybody should know about Sharia law is that Sharia law is not monolithic. It's not the same. Just like every group of Christianity has a different set of dogma, every group of Islam has a different set of Sharia, and that can be changing based on geography, based on ethnic background, based on culture. Mm. There's so many different things that change. In fact, one of the great imams of Islam, he wrote this entire fatwa and this whole concept of Sharia when he was in Baghdad, Iraq, and this centuries and centuries ago. And then when he relocated to Egypt, he wrote something completely different. And he didn't do that because he got some new understanding or he had a new revelation or something. He did that because the culture of the people compelled him to interpret Islam differently for that people. So Sharia law, in essence, is the application of Islam from the Quran and Hadith in everyday life.
Got it.
Yeah. Dustin, do you, as a North Carolina Muslim, do you anticipate the second coming of Jesus?
Yeah, actually, that's another thing I wanted to mention, is that as Muslims, we do look for the return of Christ.
Really?
We look for him to return because Jesus is Messiah in Islam. Jesus is, the unique, created individual of God. And, you know, it's oversimplified to say that he was just a prophet because he's a very important prophet. He's a unique prophet. You know, he was a prophet that was created in the womb of his mother without an earthly father, just like Adam was created without an earthly father or a mother.
So what does that mean? This is new information to me because I had always thought that, the Muslim view on Jesus was that he was just another prophet. I didn't know that they believed that he would be, coming back. What is are there parameters on that, as far as when it's supposed to happen, where it's supposed to happen? Are there any sort of predictions in the hadiths or the Quran? I don't recall reading that.
There are signs for the end of days, just like there are in Christianity, there's signs for the end of days. As a matter of fact, I was raised Christian. I taught Sunday school and was studying to be a preacher before I left Christianity. So my background in this is a little different from most convert Muslims. But anyway, I can say that there are probably about 500 signs that are listed in Hadith, that are listed in the Quran. And, the signs for the end of days, one of the major one is that Jesus will return. And we're told very specifically that Jesus will return during a prayer, that he'll be flanked with angels, that he will pray behind the imam. He will not, supersede him. And then after that prayer, he's going to lead everybody in a prayer that has never been done before. And then he will lead the faithful to eradicate everything that stands against God, which is pretty much in keeping with the book of Revelation of John.
So I'm curious, and I don't imagine, I've certainly not come across too many people in general who are Muslim in my life. There are a couple of really cool guys in the Liberty Movement Dobby Barker is one of them, and you know, it's always fun to talk to him.
I have a lot of respect for him.
Yeah, he's a great guy and a killer activist as well. But you said you used to be a Christian and now you're a Muslim and you used to teach Sunday school, and I'm just interested to know your story. You know, how did that change for you? Because, you know, most people, they grow up going to wherever church their parents go to, and they just kind of keep going in that direction, or, you know, they'll maybe fall away from that and not just not go to church anymore, that kind of thing, and or become an atheist. But, you know, you actually changed from Christian to Muslim, so I think that might be an interesting story. I'd like you to tell it if you got time coming up. It's Free Talk Live.
By now, you may have heard a bit about Bitcoins, but did you know Bitcoins are now over an $8.5 billion market? And did you know that over 65,000 businesses now accept Bitcoins? Listen, if you're already earning Bitcoins or trying to make money in the Bitcoin market, you've got to know BidBit.co. Why? Because BidBit.co is where you can easily receive Bitcoins by selling and auctioning off your own personal items or promote business products and services for Bitcoins. You heard right. Whether personal or business, you can now buy, sell, and auction your products and services quickly, easily, and securely for Bitcoin at BidBit.co, the first and only marketplace website to offer BidBit escrow, a proprietary technology which gives buyers and sellers security and peace of mind because all transactions are protected. Start today. It's free to join, free to post, free to auction, and free to bid at BidBit.co. Buy, sell, bid, or auction everything Bitcoin. That's www.bidbit.co.
BidBit.co. Store again.
What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 70% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. From demonstrations and vigils to outreach and volunteering, there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the liberty media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more, all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at freekeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at freekeene.com. That's freekeene.com.
Liberty activists around the country are starting to realize politics alone won't set us free. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks, we believe the answer starts with living your principles, spreading ideas, and connecting with those around you. By starting a Liberty on the Rocks network, you can make a difference by uniting libertarian thinkers. Find out how much fun it is to build your local network from the ground up. Visit libertyontherocks.org today to get started.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
Excuse me, is this where I get a license to start a new business?
I wouldn't be hasty. You have to get a license to go out of business, too, you know.
Oh, well, look, I've invented this little anti-gravity machine, see?
Oh, is that why you're walking 2 inches above the floor?
Oh, yes, it's very comfortable. It saves on shoe leather.
Yeah, well, you have to fill out these forms and report to the Human Services Department of Manpower Orientation and register with the Fair Employment Practice Commission, and Hour Division of the Employment Standards Administration, the State Sales and Income Tax Division, the Internal Revenue Service, and the Social Security Administration of the Department of Health, Education, and Welfare, and, of course, OSHA.
OSHA? I thought that was a little town in Wisconsin.
You'll find out. Say, floating around like that could be dangerous. Have you checked with the Consumer Product Safety Commission?
Well, not yet.
Come to think of it, you actually are flying, aren't you? Look, you need to go over to the Federal Aviation Administration and the Transportation...
It's very hard to get anything done these days if you're in business, but free enterprise built this country. Think what could happen if we don't keep it free. A public service of this station and the Center for the Defense of Free Enterprise, Bellevue, Washington.
Besides, we just can't have people floating about unregulated, you know.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live. Dial in here toll free at 855-450-FREE. We'll continue on with what some Americans are saying about why they think the country is on the wrong or the right track. And you're certainly welcome to share your thoughts here. 855-450-FREE tonight in the studio. Ian here.
Rich Paul.
And Johnny Ray.
And you can join us on Skype as well. Our Skype username is lrn.fm. Coming up, Johnny Ray's got not just a game of the week, but also wants to talk about open borders. We can do that here first. We do have Dustin in North Carolina, who is a Muslim who has converted from Christianity. And I'm just curious to how that happens exactly. You know, I just don't come across enough people in my life that are Muslim, number one, to really be able to hear this answer very many times. I want to hear what Dustin has to say about that. But first, I want you to know about Hack the Trackers. Is privacy dead? Well, not if you have anything to say about it. On November 7th and 8th, coders, privacy specialists, and idea people of all stripes will join together for Hack the Trackers, a transparency and privacy hackathon brought to you by Ghostery. You can enter online or join them in person in New York City and create tools that make the web a more transparent place or help users manage how much data they share. The hacks will be judged by experts and voted on by an online community, and winners will receive a prize package, including the all-new Black Phone, a secure-by-design smartphone for people who recognize a need for privacy and want a simple, secure place to start. Participation is free. Registration is open now. Visit hackthetrackers.com for more information. That's hackthetrackers.com. Dustin, the Muslim in North Carolina, one of them, is back with us here on Free Talk Live. Dustin, tell me your story. You are how old now, and how long were you a Christian?
Well, I'm 39, and I was raised in Christianity. I left Christianity when I was in university, and I left it because when I was studying the New Testament theology and studying it in the original languages. And
were you at a religious university?
No, actually, I was not at a religious university.
So you were just doing that on your own, then, that level of study.
It was a university course, but it was kind of a stepping stone. I was taking these courses so that I could finish my secular education and go into religious education.
Uh-huh.
But, you know, I didn't leave Christianity for Islam. I left Christianity because I felt like the tenets of Christianity and the way it was practiced today were not founded in what I was finding in the Bible itself.
Hmm.
So just to be clear, I left Christianity on the merits of Christianity and, you know, also some other issues that were going on. And I just studied every religion I could possibly find.
Hmm.
And it was my parents, actually, that led me to Islam. My parents, who were veterans of the Vietnam War and the Persian Gulf War, and you know, they both had served in the Air Force and Air National Guard. And my mother had a really wild conversion story, and I can't really tell her story as well as she can. She actually wrote a book called Memoirs of a Hillbilly Muslim, and people can get that at our website if they want, at litbylinda.com, lit-by-linda.com. And that book, she really explains everything, and it's this huge journey with dreams and vision quest and all that kind of stuff.
Wow.
And you know, so it was like, it was such a compelling event for it to happen to my mom, for her to convert to Islam, and for my dad to convert to Islam, and you know, and they were middle-aged at the time. So I said, well, shoot, I have got to study this and see you know, what it is.
So she was, were they, just to clarify, were they Christians when they became Muslim?
Yes.
And wow. And, so she had some sort of set of visions to encourage her to leave Christianity.
Well, see, that's also the kind of a misnomer. From our perception, we don't look at it as leaving Christianity to become Muslim.
Good point.
We look at it as becoming Muslim helped us to grow in our Christianity, because the only thing that we stopped believing is we stopped believing that Jesus is God or the Son of God. That's the only thing that we stopped believing. And then we started believing the additional information about the revelation that was given to the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him.
You know, I appreciate your story. You guys have any questions for a Muslim while we've got him on the line here?
No, he answered mine, which is whether one could be simultaneously a Christian and a Muslim.
Not really, because there's like a real key difference, you know, as was pointed out, that Jesus to a Muslim is not the Son of God. One of the Son. I mean, you know, if everybody's the Son of God, then he's, you know, one of the sons of God, but not the only one. Is that right, Dustin?
Yeah, that's a loose interpretation. That's acceptable. I mean, there's a huge umbrella of acceptance and understanding, and it's there's a willingness for a vast difference of opinion under Islam that everybody can still believe slightly differently and still be Muslim. I also wanted to address your main topic, if we're finished talking about Islam for a minute.
Sure, go for it.
The main topic here, you're talking about, is America on the right tracks? And quite frankly, America has been on the wrong tracks since probably the Spanish-American War. You know, we've had this constant unending aggression and this constant fight and fear of everything that's different from us. I talked with former Congressman Paul Findlay years ago about, the politics of fear and how we've been manipulated ever since, like I say, the Spanish-American War and then the Philippine-American War, which most people don't even know about. And this manipulation of public ideology through fear-mongering, through othering anybody that isn't, pardon the expression, but white Christian American. If they don't fit into the straight white Christian American archetype, then they're to be feared, to be othered, and to be attacked, assaulted, and assailed. And whoever we can demonize as a people greatest is the greatest enemy.
What were the dates of the Mexican-American War?
The Spanish-American War.
Spanish-American, sorry.
Yeah, that's 1880s, 1890s.
Okay.
Dustin, anything else you want to share?
Nope.
Thanks for the call, man.
Thanks very much for having a great program.
I appreciate it. Thank you. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We need some more of these Liberty Muslims to make the move up to New Hampshire. And I don't think Keene has a mosque in the area. I know there's, according to a Google search, there's one out in Manchester and another maybe out in the seacoast. But I don't think there's one in Cheshire County.
I don't think so.
We need to have somebody move here and open up a mosque. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Rich, you're going to be starting, or you have started, your own religion as well, which is interesting to talk about. Maybe we should do that when we get a chance. But we're going to continue on the discussion here about Americans and their thoughts on why things are on the wrong track.
Ian, I'd like to add that the politics of fear, as Dustin mentioned, is really on parade right now with ISIS and Ebola.
It's always on parade. There's always something out there that they want you to be afraid of, some sort of boogeyman or boogie thing.
I have family members, Ian, that I have a great deal of love and respect for who are terrified.
They're buying into this stuff.
Terrified of ISIS.
Wow. What is it like to be terrified of someone you've never met before or an idea that you can't even verify even exists?
And ISIS doesn't seem to show any indication of a desire to attack America directly. I mean, unless these people are actually planning on going to Syria or to Iraq, their chances of actually encountering ISIS seem pretty slim.
Yeah. What is it like, though, Johnny Ray, to be terrified of those things?
It's alien to me, too.
Yeah.
You know, I wouldn't want to live that way. And it's just, the fear isn't real. It's just so that you'll give up your own wherewithal, your own sovereignty, give up 50% of your income to the federal government to protect you.
The feds are the enemy. False belief that they'll protect you.
Right.
They have no obligation to protect you, as we saw with the riots here in Keene. There were dozens of people throwing bottles at one another in the streets and destroying property, and the police stood by and watched. I think they flew a drone over. 855-450-FREE. That's the toll-free number. You can share your thoughts here. Bring up whatever's on your mind. Free Talk Live.
Here's a good idea. When you have a legal matter like creating your will or legally setting up a business with a corporation or LLC, you don't necessarily need a law firm. Use LegalZoom.com. At LegalZoom.com, you answer straightforward questions online, and they take care of the rest. They even review your answers for common mistakes and guarantee your satisfaction. Free Talk Live listeners, you'll get 10% off your order by typing in FTL in the referral box at purchase. Don't procrastinate with these important legal documents. LegalZoom.com.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
With autumn in the air, it's time to think about getting ready for winter. And it's time to save at herbalhealer.com. You'll find amazing seasonal savings to prepare you for the fight against cold and flu season. Like oregacillin to promote lung health. 30 capsules, regularly $34.95, now only $25. HHA olive leaf, a natural antiviral, normally $16.95, now 60 capsules are just $12. HHA elderberry power, a great flu and virus fighter, regularly $16.95, 60 capsules, now $10. Save on all our homeopathic detoxes. Choose from lungs, kidney, liver, brain, libido, or whole body, normally $26.95, now just $20. Visit herbalhealer.com and click on the Fall Winter Specials button to save on all our natural cold and flu fighting products. Also, explore our Herbal Healer Academy correspondence courses that teach you how to handle your health naturally. Herbalhealer.com, healing the world with nature, one person at a time, since 1988.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippie!
Jesus.
On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, The Road to Freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
Shiny badges on your jacket. Shiny badges.
This is Davi Barker from ShinyBadges.com, and I just want to personally apologize for airing a jingle week after week, month after month, that turned out to be such an infectious brain worm. So to make it up to you, I'm offering a free gift. The next time you make a purchase at ShinyBadges.com, write WORMS in the transaction comments, and I'll send you something weird.
Do you love Twitter? Make sure you favorite the LRN.FM Twitter account so you can receive our tweets at twitter.lrn.fm. That's twitter.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You can bring up anything you'd like. Just dial in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And join us online. Go to freetalklive.com and enjoy the features that we have waiting for you there. You can interact with us via Skype as well. Our Skype username is lrn.fm. Here in the studio, you've got Ian,
Rich Paul,
and Johnny Ray.
So, again, toll-free number, 855-450-FREE. We were sharing some quotes from Americans and giving their thoughts on the reasons why they answered the way they did in this study, the Wall Street Journal and NBC News telephone polls over 1,000 or about 1,000 registered voters conducted this month, asking folks, you know, do you think the country's on the right track or the wrong track? And 65% said the wrong track, 25% Only one out of four said the country was moving in the right direction. But the question was, well, why? Why did you answer the way that you did? That's the most interesting part of this, because everybody's all over the map. I mean, all kinds of people are upset at the government for all manner of different things. One thing, that's one thing that can unite people in the United States, if anything, is their distaste for the state and for all of its failures, whatever it is that they're, you know, even if they like the idea of the state, they still don't like the current state because it's not their state. They're not in charge, and the politicians who aren't doing things how they would like to see it done.
Surprise, surprise, surprise.
So one lady says that she's upset about the health care because a lot of companies aren't hiring. This is a middle-aged white Democrat female. She says they're not hiring because they have to pay health insurance. The minimum wage is disgusting, she says. People are not making a living on minimum wage. Anything under $10 an hour is not a wage. I believe that the minimum wage should be raised. And she's not alone, Lord. Is she, Rich Paul?
No, you hear people saying that all the time. And it's funny that the juxtaposition is she's talking about people not hiring somebody because, you know, they have to buy them health care, and then saying we should raise the minimum wage. Well, let me tell you, folks, in the world of economics, anything that increases the cost of employing people is going to reduce the number of people who are employed and the number of hours that they work. If you raise prices, sales falls everywhere and always.
Mm-hmm. Well, there's been studies that have been done, right? I mean, that I think Walter Block cites some of them in, I forget which book it was, but probably some of his articles.
Wage and price controls may be the most discredited idea in the history of economics.
Like economically discredited, like you can show every single time.
Everybody, there's a consensus on it, you know? Mm-hmm.
So
almost. Paul Krugman would probably cite the New Jersey study to say that the unemployment or higher minimum wages don't necessarily cause employment, but it's very close. I mean, Paul Krugman also thinks that an alien invasion would, you know, be good for the country. So, you know, Paul Krugman's out of his mind.
So, I mean, I've seen that whenever the minimum wage goes up, my understanding that people who are sort of on the edge, the periphery, if you will, like people who are unskilled and people who are young and people who are, you know, people who are in the youth category as well as people in minority groups tend to lose their jobs. It tends to be something that puts people out of work and in very specific areas.
Yeah. And when you think about it, people say, I can't raise my three kids on minimum wage. Well, why does a teenager who lives in his parents' basement and goes to high school have to earn enough to feed three kids? It doesn't make sense for that to be the minimal possible job that you can have.
Great
pays
point.
You enough to raise three kids. Where are these kids going to get experience if they have to be able to produce enough to raise three kids to get their first job?
Yeah, well, and also, you know, one of the reasons why teenagers get cut when the minimum wage goes up, as you're saying, costs are increasing. A teenager doesn't typically bring in a lot of skill to whatever the job is. They don't bring in much job experience. They're still trying to figure out showing up on time. And you want me to pay $20 an hour to somebody that doesn't even understand the basics of going to work? I'm not indicting all teenagers. I realize this isn't a true statement across the board. But your first job is usually a low-skill kind of job, a retail-style job that you're learning the ropes of working. Yeah. And when you're learning the ropes, why the hell should you get paid, the same amount of money as somebody who brings skill to the table or somebody who, has had experience at a particular job?
Yeah, I mean, basically the least skilled people are going to be the people cut first or the least desirable employees. If the employer is, you know, a racist, he might fire all the black people and keep the white people when minimum wage goes up. Now, obviously, there would be legal repercussions for that and our regime, which would make it undesirable. But
share your thoughts here at 855-450-FREE. Here's another quote from someone who is responding to this question of, you know, is the country on the wrong track? This one's a black Republican female, age 55 plus, living in New York. She says, quote, "For one thing, we haven't got wars going on or fighting."
What? That's bad.
What world Well,
it sounds like she's saying we don't and we should. So that would be two cases of being wrong from my point of view.
It's not being made clear here, actually, because it's there. Two paragraphs prior to that, the story says even those who said they thought the nation was on the right track seem to doom the future with faint praise. So I'm not real clear on what they're suggesting her answer was. But yeah, just to be in America today and to think that you don't have wars happening in which the United States is involved, what level of self-delusion would you have to be under to really believe that? Is she using the political definition, like the constitutional definition of war, where, you know, a war has to be declared in order for it to be a war? But she goes on to clarify by saying that they don't have wars or fighting. So even if she was only using the constitutional definition of war, she'd still be incorrect.
Yeah.
She's delusional. Yeah. She's an outlier.
Yeah.
Here's a quote from a young Republican man in California. Quote, I definitely think the economy's picking up a little. I just left a bank job, so I'm aware of more of that than the Obama administration. That's it. Unquote. If things seem that bad among people who are happy with where the U.S. is headed, so I guess those were answers from people who thought things were on the right track. Then what about the rest of them? Here's a Democrat, a white retirement age woman from Iowa, who said the nation's on the wrong track. She said, quote, the wars, the bombings, the terrorism, and this Ebola thing, that's not good. Social Security, is that enough? I guess I don't know what else to tell you. And that's an interesting answer from a self-proclaimed Democrat, right? She's against the wars, against the bombings. Mm-hmm. Presumably, and concerned about Social Security as well. Not necessarily a signer, you know, of a total true believer that Social Security is going to be out there to come to everyone's rescue.
It was so sad watching the anti-war movement melt when Obama got elected. And it was like, okay, guys, just because, you know, you voted for him doesn't make his wars better than Bush's wars.
I wonder, you know, what was the percentage of drop-off between 2008 and 2012 as far as the amount of Democrats who supported him in the first term and then changed their minds? I wonder how many of them dropped away.
Well, it can happen. I voted for Bill Clinton the first time, and I voted for Harry Brown in 1996.
Yeah, all right. many of the 1,000 voters named Ebola as a concern. The poll was conducted during the second week in October, just after Eric Duncan, the first person diagnosed with Ebola, died October 8th. And the first nurse was also diagnosed. An astounding 98% had seen, heard, or read something about the disease, and 70% had seen, heard, or read a lot about it, comparing that with General Motors' recall of cars linked to at least 54 accidents and deaths, where 75% surveyed on that by CNBC had known something about that. So they go on with a few other details. The absolute chart-topping boogeyman for Americans was again Congress, however. indeed, the poll's overall negativity is, quote, about Washington and about an economy that seems stuck and not improving, according to the pollster.
No man's life and property are safe when Congress is in session.
Who said that one? Was that
Will Rogers?
Toll-free number tonight is 855-450-FREE. Coming up, Johnny Ray has a game of the week. Plus, we've in recent days come across the topic yet again here on, and it'll keep coming up, about open borders. I think it's one of the most important issues that we can discuss. It's one of the most misunderstood issues in the United States today. And Johnny Ray has a story that we're not going to actually read the whole piece. Maybe an excerpt. I'm not even sure what you've got planned, Johnny Ray, but there's a lengthy sort of academic sounding piece.
I have not in any way, shape, or form have mastered this article. I think that the best is to get the ball rolling and hopefully it'll spark our conversation.
You've
about
got something
it.
To say, though, about it. There's this guy who's a sort of well-known libertarian type who's saying that open borders is not libertarian. Right?
Papa, yes.
We'll come back with it here in moments. And hour three is on the way. 855-450-FREE. You bring up anything on Free Talk Live.
Ever wonder why so many politicians violate the U.S. Constitution? Maybe they simply don't understand its principles. Fiat empire, original intent, cultural Marxism, corporate fascism, and Molon Labe explore these issues. Featuring experts like Ron Paul, G. Edward Griffin, Edwin Vieira, Pat Buchanan, John McManus, Larry Pratt, this 12-hour, 8-DVD set is available only at moviepubs.net.
Kay Oliver is part of the Tweyambe Women's Group in Jinja, Uganda. She gets old clothes, fixes them up, washes them, and then sells them at the Jinja market. She was quite happy with her success at her business, but realized that a sewing machine would really help her make more money to take care of her two kids. Free Talk Live helped her get that sewing machine. You can help us help more people by getting your coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com. Make a difference, one cup at a time. Get a free pound, try out the subscription, cancel at any time, coffee.freetalklive.com.
Ross Ulbricht was arrested by the FBI in 2013 and charged with victimless crimes in relation to allegedly operating the Bitcoin-based Silk Road black market. He has been in a prison cell awaiting trial ever since. If he did it, he's a hero for making the black market a safer place. If he did not, he's a man wrongfully accused. Either way, if you love freedom and want to end the war on drugs, Ross and his family need your support. You can learn more and help fund his defense at FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org. You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number three is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
This is the Liberty Beat, your daily source for Liberty news and activist updates, online at thelibertybeat.com. I'm Brian Hagan with your Liberty Beat for Tuesday, October 21st, 2014. Gold is trading around $1,247, silver around $17.45, and Bitcoin is trading around $382.60. Today's Bitcoin price brought to you by Express Coin, the fastest and most reliable way to buy Bitcoin. Buy Bitcoin today at expresscoin.com. Support for Liberty Beat comes from Central Texas Gunworks, your online source for firearms, firearm accessories, and ammunition. They take major credit cards and now accept Bitcoin. Visit them online at shop.centraltexasgunworks.com. In the news, on Monday, the U.S. Department of Justice announced they would begin an investigation into the Baltimore Police Department. Officials with the Justice Department, Baltimore Mayor Stephanie Rawlings Blank, Police Commissioner Anthony Batts, and others held a press conference announcing an initiative designed to curb police brutality. The news comes after the Baltimore Sun published their own investigation showing residents suffering broken bones and other injuries during arrests. The DOJ review will study how the officers interact with residents, how the department handles complaints, and review training standards. Civil liberties groups are preparing for an appeal of a California judge's decision regarding the Los Angeles Police Department and the Los Angeles County Sheriff's Department's use of automatic license plate readers. The readers are cameras mounted to police vehicles or other locations such as light poles. They are capable of capturing and storing thousands of license plates from passing vehicles. The Electronic Frontier Foundation and the ACLU of Southern California are seeking to overturn a previous ruling that sided with law enforcement, claiming that the data caught by the readers should not be released to the public. The LAPD and LASD argued that 100% of the information was part of an investigation and therefore should not be released. Water laced with salt and sugar and gallons of the nasty tasting stuff. Doctors who survived Ebola in Nigeria credited heavy doses of fluids with saving their lives, as the World Health Organization declared the country Ebola-free on Monday. That is a rare victory in the battle against the disease that is ravaging West Africa. Support for Liberty Beat comes from Marjorie Wildcraft's Grow Your Own Groceries, homegrown food on every table. That's growyourowngroceries.org. Support also comes from Midas Resources Incorporated, helping clients convert their paper 401ks and IRAs to solid gold and silver. Get their 10 Reasons book free by calling 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237. This is the Liberty Beat, for Tuesday, October 21st, 2014. Check out the website at thelibertybeat.com and like us on Facebook at facebook.com/thelibertybeat. On Tuesday afternoon, the Los Angeles City Council is expected to vote on a ban on growing genetically modified crops following support gained from local lawmakers on Monday. Council members Mitch O'Farrell and Paul Koritz introduced the measures which would ban the planting and sale of GM seeds, as well as the sale of GM trees and plants. O'Farrell said the ban would be largely symbolic since there is little agriculture within the city. As U.S. District Court Judge Gladys Kessler waits to rule in the case of force feedings at Guantanamo Bay, new information has been revealed, including a manual on how to treat detainees. Last week, the Department of Justice was granted a 30-day delay until the release of videotapes of the force feeding. The Department of Justice is expected to use the extension in order to appeal the judge's order to release the tapes. During the hearing, the United States government also submitted to the court a copy of the current standard operating procedures for force feeding at Guantanamo Bay. Lawyers with human rights organization Reprieve say the documents offer a disturbing look at the procedures used to forcibly remove detainees from their cells and then force feed them. Support for the Liberty Beat comes from Sovereign Living, a podcast, blog, and reality show about what it takes to live a voluntary and natural life. Check out the blog at sovereignliving.com and watch episode 1 of the soon-to-be-released reality show at sovereignliving.tv. Support also comes from the Be the Media Workshop and Mini Conference, featuring Adam Kokesh and Derek Bros, along with a special Skype appearance by Ben Swan. It happens this Saturday and will be live streamed at thelibertybeat.com/be the media. Be the media and change the world. This is the Liberty Beat for Tuesday, October 21st, 2014. I'm Brian Hagan, reporting. Reminding you, spread liberty with a smile.
The Onion looks back at this week in history. On July 21st, 2007, Harry Potter and the Deathly Hallows, the final installment in the widely popular Harry Potter series, was released, as excited fans all over the world eagerly flipped to the book's final pages to find out if Harry and Lord Voldemort finally
Author J.K. Rowling had already succeeded in creating one of the most popular literary franchises of all time. And of course, much of that success was owed to the expertly crafted sexual tension that steadily built up between the series' protagonist, schoolboy wizard Harry Potter, and the Dark Lord Voldemort. Everyone in the country wanted to know whether or not they would f***, and if they did f***, how many times would they f***, and who would be f***ing who.
And that was what happened this week in history. In the words of Mother Teresa, if there is one lesson to learn from the past, it's that no matter what you do, there will always be a bunch more crippled dying kids.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live. You can bring up anything you want. Just dial in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733 with you tonight. Ian here.
Rich Paul.
And Johnny Ray.
And, of course, you can join us via Skype. Our Skype username is lrn.fm. Coming up, Johnny Ray wants to talk about open borders. And we got the Johnny Ray Game of the Week also still to come tonight. Tom is with us in Virginia to kick things off this hour, though. Tom, you're on Free Talk Live.
Hey, man, how's it going?
Tom, what's on your mind tonight? Go ahead.
So I came out of like an event the other day that was going on for helping rescue dogs and stuff, and there was a guy campaigning for Senate in 2015.
Ew.
And, you know, he's campaigning for...
Hey, can you do me a favor and back off your phone by, like, I don't know, a half inch or an inch or something like that? There's a lot of distortion.
Is that better?
Not really, but go ahead.
Hold on a sec. So he's campaigning for, like I said, for Senate, and he's free market and greater control of regulations and bureaucracies, education, healthcare. You know, he says he loves liberty, thus pro-life, NRA, Tea Party, and Family Foundation. And I don't know. I don't think.
Sounds like a Republican to me. It doesn't sound like he's necessarily pro-liberty. I mean, all these Republicans say they're pro-liberty, but they're not.
Right. And I guess my thing is, they're all crooks. Like, what's your guys' opinion on voting?
Oh, well, I know Johnny Ray feels very strongly against it. I am in favor of doing anything that can increase freedom in our lifetime. And if there's someone worth voting for, then I will absolutely support that candidate and I will vote for that candidate. Rich Paul, what do you think about voting?
I will vote for what I consider to be liberty candidates, which means they don't want to expand government in any area. They want to significantly reduce the size and scope of government, and the other requirement is they can't be racist or crazy.
How would you test this candidate that he's talking to, Rich Paul? I mean, to see if they're worthy of voting, because he's saying he's pro-liberty.
Well, I would ask, what is the government not doing enough of? And I'll bet that he would come up with something.
That's a good question. So, Johnny Ray, do you want to give your viewpoint on voting?
It doesn't make any sense to me. The government is evil through and through. So the only smart thing to do is to do your best to put as much distance between yourself and the government as possible. I would like the government to be gone root and branch, and I don't think that voting, that participating with it, helps further that end.
Now, do you distinguish between New Hampshire and the rest of the nation? Because as a result of the Free State Project in New Hampshire, we've actually got anarchists in the legislature, and that's successfully been done through voting. So don't you have to give, you know, if nothing else, to support the activism of other free staters, isn't it worth giving those people a vote?
I'd say the jury's still out. I mean... we've got people elected. I think the electoral results in New Hampshire for libertarians and liberty-minded people beat it anywhere else.
Yeah,
and,
that's true.
And
yeehaw.
We legalized knives, I think.
That's right.
Jury nullification
and also
medical marijuana, gay marriage.
Also prevented the state having the police get the license plate scanners. That was a recent victory. It's New Hampshire's the only state that doesn't have those.
Yeah, we're still holding off the sales tax. We're still holding off the income tax.
Holding off the seatbelt law.
Yeah.
As well. So Johnny Ray, it's good that you can and acknowledge that, you know, at least the political system here in New Hampshire has been responsive, unlike most places where, you know, the people worth voting for aren't, or there's nobody worth voting for, or next to no one worth voting for. And of those people who are elected, they don't ever get anywhere or do anything. So there you go, Tom. There's your answer. Anything you want to share
further?
What
do you think about voting, Tom?
I used to be a giant statist. Served in the Marine Corps, served in prisons, worked in law enforcement, and got away from all that. And, you know, I used to vote and all this stuff. And lately, I just kind of you know, it really comes down to they're all going to pitch you whatever everyone wants to hear. And then when they get in, they're going to do whatever they want. And to be honest, a lot of them really don't, you know, Senate, Congress kind of run the country, but, you know, the higher political figures, they're public figures. That's all they are. They don't actually run anything or make the large decisions, you know?
Yeah, I agree 100%. I don't think that the president is the most powerful man in the world. I think there's somebody who gives him his marching orders.
There was actually an article about that in, was it Boston? Some Boston newspaper? I've got it bookmarked here. It's too long to get into tonight. Yeah, the Boston Globe. An article about the secret government. Tom, thanks for the call tonight. I appreciate hearing from you. So I'd like to hear a little bit more, Rich, of where you might have been going with Johnny Ray with some of your questions about this. Because I've tried needling him on this issue and trying to persuade him that the political system in New Hampshire is accessible and can work to increase freedom. Because I think Johnny Ray, you know, your viewpoint, while I appreciate it, I mean, I can appreciate the idea of separating oneself from the state and see the value in doing that. But at the same time, if they want to come after you, they'll come after you. And even if they don't happen to come after you, they're still coming after other people who are innocent and who have not harmed anyone else. And I feel like as liberty-oriented people, we should do what we can to put a stop to that aggression.
Now, if the state would come to me and they would say, okay, Rich Paul, you don't like this whole state thing. So I'll tell you what, you stop voting and we'll just leave you alone, then
deal.
I would say, deal,
yeah.
Down. You know, I'll stop voting and you crazy bastards do whatever the hell you want to each other.
Yeah.
Because I don't want any part of it. But
yeah, if you could opt out, yeah, I'd be opting out completely.
Oh, absolutely. Even if I had to, you know, go to Robert Heinlein's Coventry where they just fenced off a state and put all the anarchists there, I'd be down. That would be paradise.
If you could opt out, I'd never vote again, because then all I'd have to focus my efforts on would be to encourage other people to opt out.
Absolutely.
That would be my new activism at that point.
Everybody finds their own line.
Yeah. What's your line? What's your line that would make you want to actually cast a vote?
Would you vote for me, Johnny Ray?
Rich is planning on running for political office in 2015.
I wouldn't vote for either of you guys. I might vote for myself. Ian, we talked about that.
I would vote for you.
Last time.
I'd vote for you, Johnny Ray.
They say there's no such thing as bad publicity, but I don't believe it. Ian, you're universal. You're reviled. And your political support, I don't need it.
That's true. There's actually an argument that having me on your political team will actually damage the campaign. There were a couple of elections that happened here in Keene a few years ago where I went out to a voting location and stood all day long holding a sign for the candidate. And every time I did that, that voting location would turn out to be the worst of all the locations. So it's one of those things where, you know, well, did that have to do with me being there, or would it have been like that anyway? Did I hurt the person's votes? I don't know.
Also, I think a person should do what they are most talented at doing. Mm. A person should make it one of their goals in life to figure out what they're best at and what is best for them to be doing. And if you discover that that's to be a politician, then brother, I feel sorry for you. I wouldn't wish that on anybody.
Well,
and I don't think that, and I don't know what else to say. I'm sorry. Go ahead, Ian.
Well, yeah, I certainly don't think I'm best at being a politician, and I'm not interested in doing that. I put next to zero effort into the political campaigns that I run. I mean, my campaigns are just outreach campaigns. They're message campaigns. The purpose of them is not to win. The purpose is to get the ideas of freedom out to as many people as possible without spending as much, you know, without spending any money. Like, I'm not willing to put money into yard signs to have them stolen and, you know, thrown away and graffitied and all that stuff. I'm not interested in putting time and effort into the political, you know, running for political office beyond, you know, a media interview. Because with a media interview, then that's my opportunity to do outreach. That's my opportunity to express the ideas of voluntarism in a format or in a system where those ideas aren't being heard. That's why I was so grateful when I was invited to the gubernatorial debate here in New Hampshire. I had 10 minutes. I used 7 of them to give a speech in front of the Republican debate for governor where I attacked the state while standing in front of their own flag. I mean, it was really a lot of fun. We're coming up.
Groovy.
Have you thought about owning gold? There are lots of reasons to own precious metals. A hedge against inflation. When the dollar tanks, metals go up. A barter currency. You can disempower the Fed by using real money. And no one knows the future. In an economic collapse, metals are likely to be a currency. Do as I've done for years. Buy your gold and silver and precious metals from Midas Resources through gold.freetalklive.com. That's gold.freetalklive.com. Ross Ulbricht was arrested by the FBI in 2013 and charged with victimless crimes in relation to allegedly operating the Bitcoin-based Silk Road black market. He has been in a prison cell awaiting trial ever since. If he did it, he's a hero for making the black market a safer place. If he did not, he's a man wrongfully accused. Either way, if you love freedom and want to end the war on drugs, Ross and his family need your support. You can learn more and help fund his defense at FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org.
Hi, this is Mark Edge, host of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the very economic engine that powers this country. With a printing press tethered to Washington politicians, bureaucrats, and central bankers, how can we put our trust in paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Come see gold.freetalklive.com or call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold. With Washington, D.C. delivering more debt and printed promises, common sense tells us the future of the trend is obvious. Everyone listening should visit gold.freetalklive.com
or call 877-357-9938. I trust Midas Resources for my gold, silver, platinum, and you can too. Again, I want you to have this book, and it's free. It's gold.freetalklive.com or 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938.
Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world. So I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here, and I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com. Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
Americans are reeling from Obamacare, higher prices, and an epidemic of policy lapses. AsiaRunLikeHellGuide.com has you covered. World-class medical and surgery at one of Asia's most modern hospitals. 300 doctors, surgeons, and dentists serving 300,000 patients a year. Fractions of U.S. prices. Friends or family forced to go out of pocket? Avoid bankruptcy. Tell them to run. Run like hell. Hit us up now. We'll show you how. AsiaRunLikeHellGuide.com.
Listen to LRN.FM on any phone, anytime. 213-493-0309. That's 213-493-0309.
Free Talk Live. Dial in toll-free here at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733 here on Free Talk Live. We are big fans. We may not agree on voting, but I think pretty much all of us agree. Alternative currencies, good idea.
Absolutely.
Yeah. So silver, gold, Bitcoin, these are three of my favorites. And silver and gold, of course, have a long track record of being very successful hedges against inflation. You know, we were briefly talking about the terrible system of government here and their Federal Reserve Bank that could just print out as much money as they want to and give it to their cronies in industry. With, of course, gold and silver, you're protected against that inflation of the money supply. Historically, there's a lot of evidence for that. So you can get gold and silver, various different beautiful pieces, numismatic pieces available through Midas Resources. Just go to silver.freetalklive.com or gold.freetalklive.com. It'll take you to the same place. Or call Midas Resources toll-free at 877-857-9938. That's 877-857-9938. Or again, go to gold.freetalklive.com as we go to your phone calls and thoughts. John is in Minnesota, northern part of the state, listening to WNMT. Hey, John.
Yeah, I have a question here. What is your explanation of ranked choice voting? I'll hang up and listen to it on the
radio.
You,
wait, before you do that, describe what that is?
Well, ranked choice voting, what I think it is you vote for who your first choice is, no matter whether you think they're going to win or lose, who your first choice is, and then if they can't make it, who you would recommend second, you'd vote for second.
I believe, and thank you for the call tonight, John, I believe that that is better than the system that we have today. What do you guys think?
I think that would be better, or a proportional representation system where maybe you could have one or two libertarians running statewide for the House of Representatives and vote for them no matter where in the state you live.
That's interesting.
That's how parliamentary systems usually work, and it's the reason that there will be more than two parties represented in your average parliament.
There's a lot of changes that can be made to most of the voting systems across the United States, but one of the biggest changes, I think, should be to allow third parties to have the same ballot access as the Republicans and Democrats. Here in New Hampshire, that's one of the problems. I mean, New Hampshire may be the freest of all the 50 states, and there's a good argument for that. But there's some real issues that the state does have, and inside the system, one of them is that it's terrible to run as a Libertarian or Green Party or, you know, you fill in the blank, whatever third party here in the state. They make it very, very difficult in comparison. And if it were the same level of difficulty, if they made it so a Libertarian's level of difficulty is the same as Republicans and Democrats, then it'd be a cinch. All you'd have to do would be to throw $2 in, and if you wanted to run for state rep, Republicans and Democrats, they have to file a $2 filing fee, which is really nothing at all in comparison to other states. And the Libertarians, on the other hand, the third parties who want to run for state rep, have to collect 150 signatures from people who live in their specific district. So it's a much higher burden. If you want to run for governor, for instance, I ran as a Democrat for governor this year in New Hampshire, which we were talking about briefly earlier. And for me to run for governor, because I ran as a Democrat, it only cost me $100. I went in, threw him a $100 bill, signed the whatever tiny little sheet that I had to sign to jump into the race, and boom, I was in. I was one of three competitors in the Democratic primary, and I got second place with 4%. But, you know, I did better than I thought I would do. I was hoping I'd get 1%, so I did four times better than I was hoping for. And it only cost me $100, but if I wanted to run as a Libertarian candidate for governor, I would have had to gotten 3,000 petition signatures, 1,500 of them from each of the congressional districts, I guess, or whatever they're called in New Hampshire. So that's a lot of signatures, and the only real way to get that level of petitioning done, you can't count on volunteers to collect thousands of petition signatures as much as you might like.
You've got to pay for it.
You've got to pay for professional help, which means you're going to be paying at least $1 a signature, typically. Mm-hmm. So that's $3,000 right there, but it's not $3,000 to get 3,000 signatures. You need to get at least 5,000 signatures if you want to have 3,000 real signatures. If you want 3,000 signatures that the government can't disqualify them because they're going to try to hack off as many of them as possible. Oh, well, we can't read this person's writing. We can't. Oh, this person's not registered there. You know, they'll come up with all the reasons they can to disqualify as many as possible. So really plan, if you got to get 3,000, plan for 5,000 or 6,000. So now you're up to $6,000 that you have to spend just to get on the ballot as a third party member. And then, of course, even once you get on the ballot as a third party, then you still have to deal with climbing over the obstacles that the media throws in your way, like, you know, saying you can't get into a debate unless you've got 10% in some sort of poll. So therefore, you know, because you can't get to that percentage, you can't get any media to help you get to that percentage. It's like a chicken or the egg thing. You know, how do you deal with that? So even if you could spend the money, even if you did spend the money and the time that was necessary to get to the point of being able to get on the ballot as a third party, you've exhausted most of your campaign funds at that point just getting on the ballot. And you know, and then you still have to deal with all the baggage, if you will, of being a third party candidate.
Yeah, Democrats and Republicans whine because free staters will go in and they'll run as Democrat and right. Republican and they'll win. And people will say, well, you're really Libertarians, aren't you? Well, if they would stop rigging the game, we would stop taking their party away from them.
Our Friday night co-host, Daryl Perry, actually put forth legislation last year. He's not a state rep, but in New Hampshire, if you write up your own legislation, you can just usually find a state rep who will take it and submit it. So Daryl wrote up legislation that made it fair. For, you know, the parties. It made it actually, you know, non-discriminatory or a lot more fair. Maybe it wasn't exactly the same, but it was a lot better, if not exactly the same. Mm-hmm. And the elections committee, the bureaucrats or the politicians who, the 15 politicians who sit on this committee deciding these matters, they voted almost, I think it was almost unanimous. I think maybe there was one person who wasn't there that day. But, you know, besides the person who wasn't there, I believe it was unanimous against his proposal. And then they brought it to a vote in front of the full state house, because even though the committee kills something, if in New Hampshire, if the committee kills they vote to ITL, I can't say kill, but they vote to ITL, as they call it, which is inexpedient to legislate. That's where the committee says, yeah, we don't think this is good. They come back with that. you can still have it voted on by the full House. And so that's what was done. One of the state reps who did support the idea brought that up for a vote, and it only got 29 votes out of 400.
Well, maybe we'll get enough people in as Democrats and Republicans that they can institute a fair voting system and then change party affiliation en masse to Libertarian once they would be doing it without operating at a
That'd be amazing, Rich, but I don't think it's likely. And this is from what I understand from having talked to Daryl, who has talked to a number of the state reps. There seemed to be some level of loyalty to these parties, like that this is the way to win, is to run as Republicans and Democrats, and so therefore to do things that would undermine those parties, they're not willing to do. It was actually very difficult for Daryl to find someone to sponsor that legislation. So we clearly need more liberty-minded people to move to New Hampshire to get elected. And then I like what you're suggesting. I think that the Libertarian Party here needs to be more influential, and they're not. They're in a dismal shape because most of the Free Staters are joining the Republicans and the Democrats.
Yeah, but then voting for Free State candidates.
True. Toll-free number here, 855-450-FREE. Coming up, open borders. Johnny Ray's got some comments. It's Free Talk Live.
I love My Magic Mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found My Magic Mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My Magic Mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With four, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to MyMagicMud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin. MyMagicMud.com.
This is Dan Pilla. Do you owe the IRS money you can't pay? Are tax debts crippling you? I've defended people from the IRS for over 30 years. I've helped thousands, and I can help you too. I wrote the book on IRS settlement, and I'm telling you, there's no such thing as a hopeless case. Call 800-34-NO-TAX to finally get free of IRS debt. With the IRS's new programs, there's never been a better time to solve your problem. Call 800-34-NO-TAX. That's 800-34-NO-TAX or my website, danpilla.com.
I've been told no in many different ways.
I give you an order and you're going to obey it.
Well, George, you can go this way.
You can't do that and you have to leave here.
You cannot bring Simon to the rally.
Walk with me.
Well, I'm comfortable here, actually.
Whoa, excuse me. Hey.
Who do you think you
excuse
are?
Excuse me.
There is no video and audio allowed in this office.
No, I have work today. This is...
You ain't going to make...
Wait.
You gotta go. Now.
Wait a minute.
Hey! Oh my God! Unbelievable!
Why are you running from me?
Because you're scared
of me!
What am I being detained for?
You're being served.
What is this?
You're being served.
What is this?
Bureaucrats have a funny way of telling people no. That's the sound of the men
working on the chain. Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com.
I love My Magic Mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found My Magic Mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My Magic Mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With four, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to MyMagicMud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin. MyMagicMud.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
Keenvention is coming up October 31st through November 2nd. Get your tickets now at keenvention.info. Keenvention is your chance to meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire. You can explore the beautiful little city of Keene, discuss various forms of activism with seasoned veterans, attend social events like the costume party,
Keenvention received rave reviews last year. If you missed it, visit keenvention.info for full video coverage of every speaker and panel. This year, James Robin Hood Cleveland, Rich Paul, and Free State Project President Carla Garrick will be keynoting. And we'll have all kinds of panels, including the new Cop Block panel and the new Movers panel hosted by the outlaw Josie Wales. Join old and new friends and neighbors in Keene for Keenvention this October 31st through November 2nd. Only 100 tickets are available in advance, so lock yours in now for just $60 or with Bitcoin. Reserve your tickets now at keenvention.info. Visit keenvention.info for more, or look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info.
You can interact with other LRN listeners in our message board at forum.lrn.fm. That's forum.lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live. Dial in, bring up anything here. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Join us online at freetalklive.com. And enjoy the features that we have waiting for you. Johnny Ray's Game of the Week, still to come here tonight. And open borders. Are all libertarians in favor of open borders? I know that on this show, that tends to be the viewpoint of the people behind the microphones, is that freedom should mean the ability to travel to where you are welcome. But of course, I guess you could make the argument that it's not necessarily libertarian to be in favor or against open or closed borders. And Johnny Ray, that's what you are saying, that Hans Hermann Hoppe is essentially the argument he's making. I don't know. I haven't read this piece, but you've looked into some sort of academic piece that he's written up about this issue.
I have an article from lewrockwell.com. It's by Hans Hermann Hoppe. It's an excerpt from his book, A Realistic Libertarianism. And I consider myself to be an unrealistic libertarian, so that's part of why it rubs me the wrong way.
All right. Yeah, it sounds bad.
I'm against the state, and you can't have a state without borders. And I'm against the state, so that's why I'm for non-existent borders.
But you can have private borders, right? Like, you can have borders on your land. You don't disbelieve in that idea, do you?
No, I think you can have that, but I think that the systems that we have now, heretofore in human history, for property of all kinds, it's a problem that we have not figured out yet. Mm-hmm. And right now, what we have is something that's based on antiquated notions of property from medieval times, from feudal times, that is not adequate to the future or the present. So basically, what I'm giving you is a grand dodge in that the way that we have to deal with private property, the concepts and notions we have, they're not mature. They're not realized yet.
Now, one problem that I have with the slogan "No borders, no state," though, is I don't expect initially that anarchy will be will exist globally, and therefore, if most of the world has states, and there's one area of the world that does not have a state, that area of the world is going to be bordered by the rest of the world. So there has to be a separation between the area in which we do not permit their state to encroach. I kind of would expect to see a world where, you know, maybe there is an Islamic theocracy and people who want to live that way live in an Islamic theocracy, but there's also an area where there is anarchy, and there's also an area where there's a Christian theocracy, mm-hmm. and there's also an area where there's socialism being practiced. And, you know, if your views disagree with where you are, you can vote with your feet. Because I don't think we're ever going to get everybody on the same page.
No, absolutely not. I mean, you can't even get libertarians on the same page about everything. So yeah,
there would be different types of libertarian jurisdictions, and I'd probably like some of them better than others, mm-hmm. although I'd like any of them better than here and now.
I think that there can be a transition between what we have now and my really undefined system of the future of property, that could be some kind of I guess you could describe it as vigilantism. It would be private. It would be self-reliant property. There's so much property is not scarce, but in the U.S. everybody's packed and herded into and concentrated into cities. Partly because they like being in cities. They like being near each other. Mm-hmm. Also, partly, as I've said many times before, the federal government owns a majority of the land, of the real property in the U.S. in the form of national parks mostly.
I don't know about a majority. The last number I heard was 33%.
West of the Mississippi, it's probably a majority.
I think it is, but it's lower on the east side. Of the Mississippi.
Yeah, I don't know what the breakdown is, but
so I think that somebody who wanted to have property, somebody who wanted to have a house and some land, or somebody who wanted to have a business and some land, they can get that for themselves and they can protect it themselves. And I really don't fear that there's going to be a great war between everybody where everybody's fighting it out over land. I think the U.S. is a lot more violent now because we are relying on the state to manage our affairs for us, and they've made a hash of it. I think that person to person, we're much more capable of creating an orderly system of property.
Yeah, I think it would be interesting to see how property evolved that idea in a free marketplace, because I agree with you, Johnny Ray. I mean, the system that we have today, it's old. I mean, the government titling system, the deeds and all of that, the way they set that up. I mean, it hasn't changed fundamentally, and you know, since the beginning, I don't think. I mean, I haven't studied it in any serious manner, but just taking a look at the system, it seems very very rickety.
Oh yeah.
So let's get into your thoughts specifically on Hoppe. What is he arguing? I mean, and is there a way to summarize this at all? I mean, I haven't read the piece. You said it's a long academic piece, which means I'll never read it just because that stuff always feels too highfalutin for my taste.
Ian, I'm afraid that there really is no way for me to summarize the article because I couldn't. I can summarize parts of it.
Yeah.
But
early... Whatever you want to share with us. I mean, whatever you feel is relevant.
Okay. All right. Well, let me begin with the opening paragraph.
Okay, sure. That seems easy enough.
Sure. This article is excerpted from the author's A Realistic Libertarianism. Left libertarians profess to apply libertarian principles more consistently than other libertarians. I've always looked down my nose. This is me, Johnny Ray, speaking. I've always looked down my nose at anybody who puts left before what they are. Because I've grown up against socialism, and that's kind of what I think of leftism is.
Okay. Hmm.
Then again, agorism is also a left libertarian philosophy.
Agorism, the idea of sort of doing business outside of the bounds of the system for the purpose of ultimately taking that system down?
Yeah, Samuel E. Konkin III, who designed the system, considered it a left libertarian philosophy, and I'm not entirely sure that I would classify it that way, but
I tend to agree that using the terms left and right to modify libertarian is problematic at best.
Well, I've always considered myself a rightist.
Is that right?
Yeah, and I think of leftism as collectivism. I think of leftism as socialism and communism. Hmm. I'll continue.
I don't know if that's what it means to the left libertarians, but I don't really know.
Uh-huh. I get the feeling that they're real big on sharing.
Which there's nothing wrong with that. I mean, we've got Shire Sharing here in New Hampshire. They're raising money for feeding people on Thanksgiving, which I think is a fine thing for them to do, and I've donated some money to that. I do find that that I can communicate better, I think, with people who are on the left, even though I was raised in a right-wing family. So, like you, Rich Paul, we've talked about, you know, tailoring our messages to our audience. You know, who are you talking to? Is it someone who's a lefty, a righty? Then you can say things differently to bring them on board with the ideas of freedom. But anyway, Johnny Ray, go ahead.
Left libertarians profess to apply libertarian principles more consistently than other libertarians. In fact, their role is to serve as Viagra to the state. This becomes apparent when one considers their position on the increasingly virulent question of migration. Left libertarians are typically ardent advocates, in particular, of a policy of free and non-discriminatory immigration. If they criticize the state's immigration policy, it is not for the fact that its entry restrictions are the wrong restrictions, i.e. that they do not serve to protect the property rights of domestic citizens, but for the fact that it imposes any restrictions on immigration at all.
Well, I guess by his definition, I'd be a left libertarian on this one, because...
Yeah, I would be mixed, but yeah, I would say left libertarian.
We'll come back with more, because I think, you know, you have to have open borders if you want freedom. It's Free Talk Live.
The event you've been waiting for is here. Lumber Liquidators, third annual fall flooring yard sale. It's your chance to get first quality, full warranty, direct from the mill flooring at unbelievable closeout prices. Like oak laminate for an incredible 19 cents a square foot. And pre-finished 3/4 inch solid maple for just $149. Plus beautiful bamboo for 63% less than other stores. Take advantage of our 20 years of savings with 20-month special financing. And get even more unheard of flooring deals in our stores. Fall flooring yard sale is Thursday through Monday only. Visit LumberLiquidators.com to find a store near you.
Do you drink coffee? Was the last cup of coffee you had really good? Free Talk Live has teamed up with BuzzBox to bring you the best of the best coffee. Shade grown, organic, top 1% grade Arabica. But what's different is for every 10 people that get their coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com, we can give another microloan through Kiva. Get a free pound to try it out. A free pound of the best coffee. Help others one cup at a time. coffee.freetalklive.com.
With autumn in the air, it's time to think about getting ready for winter. And it's time to save at herbalhealer.com. You'll find amazing seasonal savings to prepare you for the fight against cold and flu season. Like oregacillin to promote lung health. 30 capsules, regularly $34.95, now only $25. HHA olive leaf, the natural antiviral, normally $16.95, now 60 capsules are just $12. HHA elderberry power, a great flu and virus fighter, regularly $16.95, 60 capsules, now $10. Save on all our homeopathic detoxes. Choose from lungs, kidney, liver, brain, libido, or whole body, normally $26.95, now just $20. Visit herbalhealer.com and click on the fall winter specials button to save on all our natural cold and flu fighting products. Also explore our Herbal Healer Academy correspondence courses that teach you how to handle your health naturally. Herbalhealer.com, healing the world with nature, one person at a time, since 1988.
Are you making sense to the boomer mindset? I'm Holland Cook from SurvivalSpeech.com. 80 million baby boomers comprise 25% of the population and control most of the USA's wealth. As aging parents pass on, they'll control more. Boomers are 46 to 65 years old and regard themselves as midlife. They identify as neither young nor old. They're post-minivan and pre-retirement, and they don't like being called boomers. They think me. Many of the purchases boomer couples make are individual purposes. They've been experimenters all their lives. If you want their attention, tell stories and keep it simple. If something seems complicated, boomers can dismiss it as, I don't need this. And if you're looking for work, you may be applying to a boomer, so relate accordingly. From SurvivalSpeech.com, I'm Holland Cook.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
Majid lives in Nordevin, Armenia, with his wife, kids, and grandkids, all in the same house. They have cows, but to compete against the big ranchers, Majid needed to get a loan for more cattle. Free Talk Live helped him get a loan for the cows. He bought them, and now he's very happy with the expansion of his farm. You can help us help more people by getting your coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com. Make a difference, one cup at a time. Get a free pound to try out the subscription. Cancel at any time. coffee.freetalklive.com.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. Moments remain here, but enough time for you if you want to dial in now at 855-450-FREE. That's toll-free, brought to you by ProXPN, 855-450-3733, and you can join us online. Just go to freetalklive.com and enjoy the features waiting for you there. You can actually support this program. One of the ways to do that is by shopping with us at shop.freetalklive.com. You go through the Amazon links you'll find there. There's Amazon UK, Amazon Canada, and Amazon US. You just go into the right Amazon for you and get your shopping taken care of. Free Talk Live will get a cut of the purchase if you start your shopping through our links at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com. Gearing up for Keenvention. It's coming up here in just over a week from today. Friday the 31st will be the first day for Keenvention 2014, the second annual Keenvention. Rich Paul will not be in jail this time for Keenvention, so you'll actually get to attend and be speaking at this year's event. You'll be wrapping up the entire Keenvention on Sunday afternoon with the keynote speech. And so I know that a number of people are looking forward to that, Rich. So look forward to that. And you can learn more about Keenvention at keenvention.info. It's not too late to get tickets. You can actually order them all the way up through most of next week on keenvention.info. It's $60 for the entire weekend. It's basically a hotel-style convention. If you've ever been to a convention before, you'll probably realize, you know, you'll recognize similarities. We've got panels. We've got speeches, you know, that kind of stuff. What we don't have at Keenvention are the fancy big name speakers, the come flying in big name libertarian Hans Hermann Hoppes, you know, from wherever, and you know, flying them in and putting them up in hotel rooms, and thereby having to drastically increase the cost of the price of a ticket for the event. Keenvention was designed to focus on the activism happening here in New Hampshire, so the speakers are all of them are New Hampshire based speakers, although I have heard that there's going to be, well, there's one new panel that hasn't been, or there's a panel that has yet to be announced, which may have a speaker from Vermont. We're going to bend the rules a little bit to let somebody come from Vermont to speak at Keenvention, but otherwise it's 100% or darn close to it of the speakers are New Hampshire based activists.
They took our jobs.
So
that Vermonter.
So it should be fun, and we'll announce what that's going to be here in a little bit. We just announced that there's going to be a bonfire, which is a new social event during Keenvention. It's going to be happening on Halloween night.
In the hotel?
No, afraid not. That would be a problem, but there will be a generous Conan from Black Sheep Rising is going to be offering up his property as a location for said bonfire, which I think would be great. So there's social things to do while you're at Keenvention. There's panel discussions and things to do in the hotel and sort of the official curriculum of the event. And it's also an intimate affair. So if you've ever been to the Liberty Forum, which is the Free State Project event that happens in March, which is excellent, and I recommend you go to it, that's a big convention. There's 500 or 800 people, somewhere in between 500 to 800 people every single Liberty Forum. Keenvention, you might be looking at 100 to 150 people. And so it's a much more manageable, a small group, a group of this, that's the size to where you can actually meet everybody who
you can get to know your local celebritarian.
Yeah, there you go. So join us this coming, not this weekend, but the following weekend, October 31st through November 2nd in Keene for Keenvention, and learn more at keenvention.info. And by the way, you can pay for your tickets with Bitcoin. So Johnny Ray, you were reading for us the introductory paragraph of a lengthy academic piece by Hans Hermann Hoppe, who's
noted Austrian economist.
Is he a Mises guy? Is he one of those Mises guys?
Yeah.
So he's supposedly a liberty-minded guy, but he's making the argument that open borders isn't necessarily libertarian. Go ahead.
Well, he agrees with you, Ian. I'm going to paraphrase a little bit. He agrees with you in that a person should not have the right to come and live where somebody else is living.
Mm.
They don't have a right to do that. So that's... They're not free to immigrate into your house. And in fact...
So he believes in the idea of property rights.
A right to free immigration exists only for virgin country, for the open frontier. There are only two ways of trying to get around this conclusion and still rescue the notion of free immigration. The first is to view all current place occupants and occupations with moral suspicion. And I think that's... That's kind of where you look at where I look at you and say, well, Ian, this land was owned by the Indians, And the government came in and bought it with fraud, maybe. And there's been all kinds of displacements of people and illegal things happening with this property. So I look at you and I suspect that you don't necessarily have the rights you claim to the property that you have here. Mm. The second possible way out is to claim that all so-called public property, the property controlled by local, regional, or central government, is akin to open frontier with free and unrestricted access. And I brought that up earlier, and that's how I feel.
It makes sense to me. The government, supposedly government-owned land, if you agree with the philosophy that or the belief that the government is essentially a criminal gang who has acquired all of its land through violence and through the threat of violence, which you know is what taxes are, it's extortion. Then therefore they couldn't own anything legitimately in the same way that if a bicycle thief comes and steals your bicycle and then pawns that bicycle and, you know, buys something with the cash that he pawned the bike for, then, you know, he doesn't own the PlayStation, you know, whatever it was that he bought with that because he stole the bike to begin with that led him to be able to acquire that new item.
Speaking personally, I think I'm a little bit from column A and a little bit from column B. I do suspect every property owner of not having a real claim to that property because of what I was saying earlier. I don't think that we have this notion of property figured out yet. And until we do, I suspect everybody. But the thing is, also, like I said, I don't think land is scarce, so I don't think that's a real problem that our conception of property is confused.
Isn't land by definition scarce?
Yes,
I mean it's something
scarce.
You can't make more of it.
Of course. But yes, it is that way.
There's a lot of it. There's more than enough of it, I guess you could say.
Yeah. Said a different way, land is more abundant than is utilized, and that people might appreciate.
Okay.
So I think we can have these misunderstandings or these imperfect systems and still get along. But like I was saying, I'm a little bit for I think our notion of property is a little confused. So I'm suspicious of everyone. But also, I think we have all this unused federal land, unused public property that could be put to productive use, somebody could live there. And we wouldn't be fighting each other for elbow room all the time.
Now, you told me this off the air. I don't think you mentioned on the air that Hoppe in his article is saying that he doesn't agree with the idea of just letting people homestead the federal land.
Well, he says that this is certainly erroneous, the idea that public property is open frontier. From the fact that government property is illegitimate because it is based on prior expropriations, it does not follow that it is unowned and free for all. It has been funded through local, regional, national, or federal tax payments, and it is the payers of these taxes then, and no one else, who are the legitimate owners of all public property.
Well, how the hell do you figure out how to deal with that, though? I mean, even if you were to believe what he's saying there, how do you handle that in a realistic manner? All right, now all 300 million of you own this property. Okay.
Well, I mean, if I was going to cut off a piece of the government, say the Tennessee Valley Authority, if I was going to privatize that, probably what I would do is form it into a corporation and distribute one share of stock to that corporation.
To who?
To each of the people living in the area that I was going to privatize it over. But you certainly couldn't go back and track down who paid the taxes.
But, right, now you're talking about a bureaucratic nightmare. 100
years ago when this thing was built.
Now you're talking about an impossible vision for a bureaucratic distribution of property. I mean, let's divvy up 300 million shares of this federal land and then have some bureaucrats figure out to whom all those shares need to be sent. And, you know, but half of them are going to get lost in the mail. They're going to have old addresses for people. And if you've paid your taxes, if you didn't pay your taxes, you won't get the shares and they'll have to check tax records. I mean, this sounds like an insane bureaucratic process to try to deal with that. I mean, I think it would be difficult to try to do that on a town level, let alone at a state or national level. That sounds crazy to me.
It is the payers of these taxes and no one else who are the legitimate owners of all public property.
Okay, what if I came in to visit the United States? What if I came from Mexico to do some business here, and I paid some taxes while I was here. I mean, if you set foot in the United States for more than an hour, you're probably paying some kind of tax, right? Like whether it's a sales tax in most states, or you know, some sort of gasoline tax, a meals tax. Mm-hmm. I mean, anybody who spends a day in the United States has paid taxes. So by that definition, that would open up a good chunk of the world's population to ownership of that land.
According to Hoppe, the answer is clear, Ian.
Oh, yeah?
A trustee's guideline regarding immigration would be the full cost principle. That is, the immigrant or his inviting resident should pay the full cost of the immigrant's use made of all public goods or facilities during his presence.
Got no time to talk further about it, but we'll be back tomorrow night. Join us online in the meantime at freetalklive.com, where the conversation continues.
Free Talk Live, the show where anyone can call about whatever they want. And we do mean anyone.
You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Helen.
About almost three decades ago this fall, little creatures appeared in my consciousness.
Little creatures?
They introduced themselves to me as Matilda and Mumford Rabbit.
Huh.
They come from a higher planet, you know, more spiritually evolved. Matilda Rabbit has a habit of using God's gift of free speech. Matilda Rabbit has a habit of snoring in her sleep. But not before she does implore the Lord her soul to keep.
Is it the same God?
Oh, yeah. Right. Jesus is their word and way on all planets.
Why would they care about Jesus? They don't even live on this planet.
Right. How would they even know? Because Jesus was on our earth, right?
Well, Jesus is not on this planet alone. He's everywhere.
Did he, really? Did he die on a cross in outside of Jerusalem and the other planets too?
Free Talk Live. 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern. Live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
Are you tired of your taxes funding endless occupations around the world? Antiwar.com is run by people who understand that wars abroad become wars at home, wars on our freedoms. Antiwar.com is dedicated to bringing you the latest in news, views, interviews, and reviews from the top movers and shakers in the anti-occupation movement. Antiwar.com has it all, from thorough foreign policy analysis to interviews with whistleblowers who used to run the military-industrial complex. Anti-war, pro-free market. That's Antiwar.com.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's posts pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
The live edition of Peace News Now is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network, LRN.FM.
This is the Liberty Beat, your daily source for Liberty news and activist updates, online at thelibertybeat.com. I'm Brian Hagan with your Liberty Beat for Tuesday, October 21st, 2014. Gold is